You're watching MITV, McAllen Instructional Television.
Hello everyone, my name is Dr. Jay Gonzalez. I'm Superintendent of Schools for McAllen ISD. On behalf of the district and our Board of Trustees, welcome to DQ Fan Field at McAllen Veterans Memorial Stadium. We wish all those competing and performing the best of luck, and we hope all those in attendance enjoy the competition.
Welcome to the Sideline Show from Dairy Queen on North 23rd. I'm Jake Berry, Mark May. Mark, we talked about Mack High yesterday. Mm-hmm. Tonight, Memorial, at home, after coming off that tough loss to La Jolla. Mm-hmm. What do they need to do to right this ship?
I think the defense maybe needs to step up a little bit. Last week they did hold a fourth quarter lead, double digit fourth quarter lead, and then eventually lost to La Jolla by 1 point. So the defense will need to come through tonight against this PSJA team that can really light it up. They're averaging about 31 points a game and give up about 31 points a game. So they're an exciting ball team, just as Memorial is. Memorial scored a lot of points and can give up a lot of points. So if Memorial can get a couple of key stops on defense here tonight, they really stand a good chance of winning.
Yeah, this is a PSJA team that dismantled La Jolla 2 weeks mm-hmm. ago. And so, you know, Memorial is going to have to score big, but their defense, I mean, we've seen it in the past where their defense is, you know, it's taken a while for them to get going, mm-hmm. but then all of a sudden they light a fire into that team and they're explosive on the defensive end. How real is that possibility?
Pretty good, because I mean, at this point of the season, even though we have some young guys, they had mostly juniors in their starting lineup. They picked up a lot of experience by now, so you know that should begin to start to kick in as we hit the third game of the district slate. So I would look for good things from the defense tonight. I mean, they're led by Axel Hernandez, defensive end, who was a linebacker last year. He's leading the team in sacks. Still, they have a team total of 8. In fact, he has 3 of the 8. Safety Michael Morales has 2 interceptions, and which leads the team. And then Minton Murray has been a monster at linebacker. Murray leading the team in tackles, and he had 14 last week against the La Jolla Coyotes, and that gives him 50 on the year to lead the team. So yeah, they've got some standouts on defense that can pull up some stops tonight.
And on the offensive side, we know that they have some offensive skill players. Mm-hmm. Who are the players that we should look for tonight?
Well, it'll be your usual suspects. You're going to have Campbell Spates, who had 130 yards last week and a touchdown despite the team losing by a point on the year. He's got 667 yards to lead the district there, averaging about 7.5 a carry. Has 11 touchdowns this year, 10 of them rushing. Then Sean Scugan at quarterback has been doing very well. Scugan is close to 500 yards passing and has added another 430 yards rushing. So he's very balanced in his pass and run attack there. He's thrown 6 touchdown passes and rushed for 4 more, so he's obviously a big threat. AJ Castro in certain areas has picked up some key yards out of the backfield. Ethan Bazan is their leading receiver, comes into tonight with 18 catches for over 400 yards and averaging nearly 23 yards a catch, so he really lights it up when makes things happen when he catches the football. They've gotten him open deep for a couple of long distance touchdowns we've seen. That's 4 touchdowns total. And against the Mission Eagles, in fact, last week against La Jolla, had 3 catches for 95 yards and a touchdown in that one. So it was still effective last week. And that's 3 games in a row now that Bazan has had 90 or more yards catching. So he's definitely been a key target for them the last 3 weeks.
Well, they're going to have to use him this week, and I think we have a package with them, mm-hmm. right?
Yeah, that's right. We talked to Ethan Bazan earlier this week about his top-notch receiving skills and how he catches in traffic.
Hey, stays on me on 3, 1, 2, 3,
play! Kellen Moore is a run first, so I'm a blocking wide receiver, and then I just, when my opportunity comes, I take my opportunity to get the ball and make plays, make moves. anytime I get my opportunity on a vertical or a corner route, I just try to take it and make a play out of it. Wide receiver, anybody can be a wide receiver, run a route, but it's how you run the route and how you do things here to get open, get separated is what makes you a different wide receiver than everybody else.
Two receivers to the left, and Scoogan wants to throw, has protection, going to throw it deep to the left side, and it's open, and it's caught, and it's Bazan, gets away from his man at the 45, now it's a foot race toward the end zone, it's at the 10, man dives, and Bazan escapes into the end zone, touchdown!
That's a huge play, Mark. They didn't want to go two possessions and get nothing out of it.
Welcome back to the Sideline Show, and you know, when we talk about the stiff competition in this district, mm-hmm. PSJA right now sits above everybody, right there with Roe, for you know, at the top spot of the district. Trey Guajardo, what can you say about that kid?
He's just an excellent, one of the best quarterbacks in the Rio Grande Valley. He was the District 31 6A MVP last year, as they were in a different district, District 31, and he has been a four-year varsity starter. And so he's got a ton of experience, and this year he's leading the district with a ton of yards, 1,600 passing yards.
Only.
Yeah, only 1,600, which puts him ahead of last year's pace. He was about 2,900 last year. So he's on a pace for over 3,000 yards this season. Completed 69% of his passes. And look at this interception to touchdown ratio. 15 touchdowns, only one interception.
Incredible.
So as often as he puts the ball in the air, he keeps it away from opponents. So he's an excellent player. Also, he's the second leading rusher on the team, so he's a running threat also, and is, you know, just tons of problems that you have to cope with defensively for a player like this. Has thrown for over 300 yards 8 times in his career, and last week is coming off, or rather, I'm sorry, a couple weeks ago back, he's coming off a 500-yard performance. That was his career high. So just
only
2 weeks
500
ago,
yards.
Yeah, three yeah. for 501 yards, and a big win. That was against La Jolla 2 weeks ago. So then running back J.R. Vasquez, who's only a junior, stands only 5'9", but he leads the team with over 300 yards rushing. This is a team that doesn't run it very much, much like La Jolla that we talked about yesterday. This team, it relies on throwing the football. Miguel Flores is their leading receiver, 35 receptions and 5 touchdowns this year. He's coming off season high of a couple weeks ago against La Jolla, also 10 receptions for 217 yards in that game, so he can really light it up. In fact, he caught 3 touchdown passes in that game against La Jolla. And his teammate on the other side of the ball, Manny Castillo, Marco Guajardo, he caught another 3 touchdown passes. So those two guys, 6 touchdown passes between them against La Jolla. And then defensively, they've got some pretty good guys. And linebacker Jacob Sanchez is their leading tackler of over 50 tackles. Defensive lineman Manny Castillo has a couple of sacks and over 50 tackles. And then the defensive back Juan Zambrano is a real ball hawk with 3 interceptions and 2 fumble recoveries. So that's a guy who has a nose for the football and knows how to get it and provide short fields for the PSJA offense. So yeah, PSJA definitely a formidable team on both sides of the ball. Remember, they were 8-0 last year and then lost their last 3 right at the end of the season. They're a team that's kind of picked up the momentum back from where they were midseason last year. They're 3-2 overall, still a good team. They lost their season opener to Flower Bluff, which is a 5A team, but a good one. They're 4-1 up there. And Corpus Christi King, they beat 55-45 in a shootout. That's kind of a typical PSJA score this year. King also a 5A team and kind of down this year as
yeah.
well.
And they played San Benito, and that was their yeah. other blemish. That was their Valley blemish.
Uh-huh.
And that one, it was, I believe, 47-20.
Yeah, you're right, 47-20.
And, you know, and that San Benito is still San Benito. They're mm-hmm. They're a pretty stout team. So, you know, they were playing stiff competition, you know, in that game. But for Memorial, what do you think the keys of the game are going to be for them to win this one?
I think they need to limit the PSJA possessions as best they can. So it's really crucial for Memorial not only to score, but to have time-consuming drives. You know, if they have 2 and 3 play drives for TDs, that kind of puts it right back into PSJA's hands. It keeps your defense out there. Possibly they tire over 4 quarters. But I think if Memorial can have some time-consuming drives, it keeps the ball, keeps the PSJA offense off the field, keeps the ball out of Guajardo's hands. And if they can limit the touches for Guajardo, then they stand a very good chance of beating this Bear team.
All right. Well, when we come back, we're going to take a quick break. When we come back, we'll have a little bit of info, a little bit of knowledge about the Roe Warriors. Welcome back to the Sideline Show. Jake Berry, Mark May. Mark, we're welcoming back somebody. You know, we're going on the road to face them, but we're going to have a Kaufman versus Kaufman battle.
That's right. Yeah, we've got Marcus Kaufman, the head coach of the PSJA North Raiders, and his wife, Mrs. Monica Kaufman, is the principal at Nicky Rowe High School. So interesting. I mean, it'd be interesting conversations around the dinner table this week. But I know they'll take it in stride, and should be a good game between Rowe and PSJA North. A contrast of styles here. This
Very
is
much.
Like a boxer puncher kind of matchup. You've got the high octane offense in Nicky Rowe, and then you've got the stout defense in PSJA North. This is a North team that has gotten 16 sacks this year in only 5 games. That's over 3 sacks a game. So they're a team that can certainly put pressure on the quarterback, and I think that'll be a big key for Rowe if they can protect Jonas Ortiz, give him time to throw, then Ortiz will find the open man and Rowe will win. But if not, then it could be a long night.
And Rowe's offensive line last week played very well against Waters Lincoln. They're going to have to do it tonight because, you know, you look at PSJA North, it's a reflection of their coach. They want to get after it. They want to find the QB.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and Coach Kaufman used to be the offensive coordinator at McAllen Memorial, so he knows Nicky Rowe very well, even though this is the first time Far North and Rowe have been in the same district in many years. But Far North, they averaging 27 points a game. They give up about 22, so they like to keep it scoring on the low side. A little bit of their balance tilts a little bit in favor of the rush, almost 250 yards a game rushing and a little less than 200 yards a game passing. Isaiah Ronhell's their quarterback. He stands 6'3", so he's a player who can see over the line, has thrown for 700 yards and 9 touchdowns this year, and rushed for 460, averages over 7.5 yards a carry. So he's certainly a pass-run threat there that will give Rowe's defense something to think about tonight. And then their top running back, Isaac Gonzalez, leads the team with 11 yards a carry. He's just a freshman running back, getting 11 yards a carry, close to 400 yards on the season. Arturo Beltran is their leading receiver. He's another tall, lanky guy, 6'1", has 20 catches and 6 touchdowns this season. So, yeah, Far North has some pretty good players. Had a lot of players, they were down last year, but they had a lot of players coming back, so a lot of experience that came back to this side.
And Rowe could have had a letdown week last week, but they weren't having that. Mm-hmm. They were electric on the offensive side of the ball.
Oh, yeah, they were. They scored 45 points against that 12 stingy Juarez Lincoln team. Jonas Ortiz, second leading passer, almost 1,200 yards passing this season. 64% completion rate is very good. Has 10 touchdown passes, including 3 touchdown passes last week against that Juarez Lincoln team, and almost 250 yards passing. Lalo Bosquez came on strong last week. He had 2 touchdown runs for the Warriors. And then Ruben Sines, their leading receiver, 22 catches for over 300 yards and a couple of touchdowns. And Ruben Salinas had a big week last week. He caught that 61-yard touchdown pass from Ortiz and ended up with 4 catches for 110 yards last week. And of course, that long-distance touchdown. So he'll be the deep threat again for this Rowe team that will give PSJA North something to think about and force them to have to respect the run and the pass equally going in there tonight. So, yeah, it should be a wonderful kind of contrast for the football purists. Love these kind of kind of matchups. It's like your pitcher hitter matchup and things like that. So it'll be fun to watch.
Mark, mm-hmm. you know, talk to me real quick. Rowe's record since they lost to Weslaco in week one, what have they been doing right?
Yeah, it's been a night and day difference since that week one opening loss. They won four straight. They're unbeaten on the road, 3-0, which really shows how prepared the team is. Because on the road, you get more distractions. It's easier to get down if you're in a tough game and things, stuff like that. So it really shows the mettle of this team that they play so well away from home. And they've just gotten better and better each week, I think, on both sides of the football. And it's showing, and it's paid off in this four-game win streak.
Well, we'll see how that game goes between PSJA North and Rowe. But for us, we've got Memorial versus PSJA, and that one should be a barn burner tonight. We'll see how it goes. Countdown to kickoff is about to begin.
Grand Valley is built on a strong foundation of family. We honor that tradition and are proud to announce that Elsa State Bank and Rio Bank are coming together to make a stronger bank for the Valley. Rio Bank, your kind of bank, your kind of banker.
And good evening and welcome to an exciting edition of Football Night in McAllen. Tonight we've got a good one. The PSJA Bears and the McAllen Memorial Mustangs. A full tilt here tonight. A District 36A clash between these two. A rivalry that goes all the way back to the early 1980s. For the first time in several years, they're back in the same district. So they'll be colliding tonight in a district game right here at DQ Fan Field. Hi, I'm Mark May along with Mario Reyna. And Mario, pretty good game here, a good matchup, a lot of talent on both sides, and how do you see it as far as your keys go?
Yes, and these two teams have been projected to either be the district champions or for sure go into the playoffs, but I went on the limb a little bit on the keys to the game. I'm going to talk about the Memorial defense. They got to play tonight because PSJA comes in here as the number one rated offense. So the defense has to do something, kind of like what PSJA North did last week. They held them down to 10 points, which was amazing. And, of course, when you look at the PSJA, their defense has to play well because we know, you know, what Memorial can do with Campbell Spates. And we got news that, unfortunately, for the Mustangs, if you want to report on that.
Yeah, their quarterback, Sean Scugan, won't be playing tonight due to an injury.
And that's a big loss for them. So I think the PSJA defense, they struggle. They're at the bottom of the barrel in the district. So they got to play, too. And then, like anything else, my third key to this game today is execution. And when I'm talking about execution, executing all the time, you know, no penalties, the fumbles, the turnovers, and of course on special teams. It is, you know, PSJA, I was, you're looking at Trey Guajardo, the number one ranked quarterback. I was observing him during the warm-ups, Mark, and I've never seen an accurate quarterback in the warm-ups like that guy. He was hitting everything right on target. He comes into this game with over, like, close to 70% completion.
Yeah, yeah, and 1,600 yards, oh, man. And 15 yeah. touchdown passes yeah. in only five games, and three yeah. touchdowns a week that he's averaging. Right. So you're right, Trey right. Guajardo, he was right. the MVP last year in District 31-6A. But talking about the Mustangs quarterback for just a moment, we'll show you some video here of the coin toss just a few minutes ago. And this is where the captains come out for both teams. You can see the Bears in white and the Mustangs in their navy blue. And you see a jersey with shoulder pads there in between them. That's the number 10 jersey of their quarterback, Sean Scugan, who won't be playing tonight. And Spates, Castro, both carrying his jersey there tonight. And then Domian and Morales, the other two captains there tonight. So they actually had five captains tonight instead of the usual four. And the Memorial is one of those games that they have the same captains every week. They don't alternate captains or anything, so it's quite an honor to be a captain for the Mustangs. And Scugan getting to participate in a manner of speaking here tonight as part of the coin toss. So you know the players will be playing for him. They'll be playing
no
for
doubt
each
about
other.
That. That's
and
the beauty
they're going to be fired up.
Of a team sport, and we know Sean's a great athlete. And we wish him the best and a speedy recovery. He's a fine young man. He was a student for my wife up there, and she had nothing but just good things to say about what a good kid he is.
And talking about these Mustangs, looking at their offense and their defense, you know, these are two exciting teams. They both score in the 30s, the Bears and Mustangs, and they both give up points in the 30s. So you could see a high-scoring game tonight. As we see, it'll be Joseph Lada who will be in there at quarterback. He's also a defensive back, so he'll be starting at quarterback. Campbell Spates, of course, a second-leading rusher in the district, close to 700 yards. He'll be in there at the running back. Then we got Castro, Ethan Bazan, who you saw on our sideline show, leading receiver on the team. And then Zion Gregory and David Paz at the tight end.
And the last time I talked about Ethan Bazan as a wild card, now I think everybody knows about him, but Gregory has to help out the offense.
Yeah, Gregory with just one catch this year. Offensive line, we've got Domian, one of the team captains, Escobar, they're the two seniors, and then Ramos Gutierrez and Dowd anchoring that line. Dowd, the heaviest man at over 300 pounds on that offensive line. Defensive line, a couple of new faces in here. Minton Quade Murray at the tackle, and also Eddie Ramon, who's at the defensive end. Those are two linebackers who have moved up to defensive line tonight. Then they've got Nick Nelson and Axel Hernandez. Hernandez, the leading sack artist on this team. Michael Pequeño and Michael Morales flanking the middle linebacker, Christian Sanchez. Sanchez, just a sophomore, and Pequeño and Morales have been playing a lot of defensive back and some linebacker hybrid, but they'll be playing
it
mostly linebacker tonight.
It doesn't surprise me that Michael Morales is now a linebacker because he doesn't have any problems coming up and hitting.
And then the secondary, you've also got some new faces here. You've got the three offensive starters in Lada, Spates, and Bazan, who are going to do double duty here tonight and play in the secondary. Then Diego Vidal, who is a anchor there at the cornerback spot. So it'd be overall nine different changes on defense from their last home game 2 weeks ago, that 42-38 win over the Mission Eagles.
And that doesn't happen often. By this week already, you would think that you pretty much stabilized your offense and your defense. So Coach Littleton, he's trying to do everything. They did lose in the last seconds, the last time they played, 29-28 to La Jolla. So he's trying to make all kinds of adjustments. It's a lot of work if you're going to be going both ways, and we'll see how that figures out in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, and that's something you don't always see as we take a look at one of the captains, the left tackle, Daniel Domian, right there as we get ready for the national anthem. We'll see how that plays out. You don't see that often in Class 6A where several players are playing on both sides of the football. Right now they're recognizing all the veterans on both sides in the stands here tonight, on the home side and on the visitor side, asking those veterans to please stand and be recognized, something like to do at every game.
Light, what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket. The bombs bursting in air gave proof through the night. that was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave for the land of the free and the home of the brave.
Very well done. A quartet from McAllen Memorial High School Choir. There we see the ROTC cadets affiliated with the U.S. Marine Corps. Private First Class Patrick Salcedo, Private First Class Todd Payton, Private First Class Stephanie Estrada, and Private First Class Carlos Vida. Excellent job there with the color guard. And of course, a great job too by the quartet under Mr. Omar Samaniego, the choir director at McAllen Memorial High School. We're about ready to play some football. Coming up in just a moment, the players are about to run out onto the field. You can see the Mustangs there in the background, PSJA to the right of your screen here at BQ Fan Field. Should be a good one between the Mustangs and the PSJA Bears. As we talked about, both teams have a lot of talent on both sides of the ball, especially on offense. PSJA's quarterback, Trey Guajardo, comes in as the top passer in the district. And J.R. Vasquez, their leading rusher, averaging 7.5 yards a carry. We took a look at the sliver of moon that's overseeing the DQ Fan Field here tonight for a lovely night of football. And then Guajardo's top targets, Miguel Flores and Marco Guajardo. Mustangs come running out onto the field. Mustangs are 2 wins and 3 losses. There's Mr. Blizzard from DQ. Mustangs are 2-3 overall, 1-1 in the district. The PSJA Bears come in unbeaten in district play at 2-0, and overall they are 3-2. And an interesting note here, Mario, the Bears, all 3 wins have come at home. Their 2 losses have both been road games, so that might be a little bit of an obstacle for them to try to overcome tonight. There we take a look at number 11, Joseph Lotta, who will be making his first start at quarterback tonight. Otto doesn't have any passes this season, but he's a pretty active player. He plays on defense, and he's also the holder on the special teams.
And he's listed on the roster as not a position player, as an athlete. So that tells you that he's pretty good all around, can do it all, offense, defense. And we'll wonder if Memorial, as Coach Littleton giving the final instructions, if they are willing to put Campbell Spates maybe in the Wildcat, see if they can create some situations.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see how they adjust offensively. Coach Littleton, in his 16th year, head coach of the Mustangs.
Seems like only yesterday.
Program history. Go ahead.
So it seems like only yesterday when he got here, he turned around a program that was struggling, and pretty much he sets the standard in this district and sets the standard that you're going to be part of a winning football tradition. And right off the bat, the Mustangs are going to be kicking off, and that means the Bear offense is going to get on the field. And get ready, Mark. Before you know it, there's going to be passes all over the place. Look for the Bears to open it up by throwing some bombs today. Secondary for the Mustangs better be ready.
Okay, Alex Cardenas is the kicker. He'll be kicking things off, and we are underway here on this Friday night, October the 12th, PSJA Bears Memorial Mustangs here in McAllen. It's the Bears returning this across the 25, across the 30 now, to about the 33-yard line. A good little return for number one, Miguel Flores, who's one of their starting wide receivers.
Ever a Costa on attack.
You see the Mustang cheerleaders. Everybody excited here for Friday night football?
Everybody's excited. Friday night football. Mark, the PSJA Bears actually have 5 receivers that come in here with like 20 catches each. So they like to be on the spread, and they like to put it in the air.
Yeah, Flores, who returned that kickoff, the leading receiver on the team with 35 receptions.
158 yards. That's a lot of yards.
5 touchdowns, so he's averaging a touchdown a game. As on the first play, they're going to hand this off to J.R. Vasquez, their running back. Surges all the way up to the 40-yard line before he's brought down by a couple of Mustangs, including Ethan Bazan and also Michael Pequeño.
And J.R. Vasquez, a junior, comes into this game with 314 yards. That's not a lot of yards, but he has a 7.5 average. That's because they don't run the ball a lot.
That does have 2 100-yard games this year.
And Trey Guajardo, while he was warming up, Mark, there's about 25 different formations. If you look at the top of the screen, Coach Lupe Rodriguez.
Yeah,
signaling into the offense as Guajardo's going to roll out to his right. Looks like he wants to run with it. Now he's going to throw it. Finds an open man at midfield. First down for the Bears into Mustang territory. The 44-yard line. Bazan upended him. Receiver Ethan Castillo, the junior receiver.
And that's the 23rd reception for Ethan Castillo. And that's part of the game that Trey Guajardo brings in. He's a very confident quarterback, very relaxed. He scrambled. Looking downfield, his initial receiver was not open. No problem. He finds a secondary receiver.
Yeah, he's a four-year varsity starter. You notice no panic on that play when the initial receiver was covered. And here's a Vasquez on first down up to about the 40-yard line. Gain of about four on the play before he was brought down.
Axel Hernandez.
The Mustangs, Axel Hernandez.
And Mark, the other thing about PSJA offense is that they have a lot of kids that are on the track team. They have a lot of speed.
Shot of Axel Hernandez right there, adjusting his pads. Defensive end, senior. Now Guajardo out of the shotgun will roll out to his left. Fire toward the sideline. This is caught by Castillo, who sheds a tackler, but is pushed out of bounds. And it looks like he picked up a first down.
Second reception for Castillo, and that makes it 24 for him for the year. And that's what Lupe Rodriguez, a star himself at quarterback when he played in Mission, he likes to roll out Trey Castillo, and it makes it real difficult for the defense to zero in on him for sacks.
That was a first down, a 10-yard pickup. So first and 10 at the 30-yard line. They run this, try to run it up the middle, but the Mustangs have it stopped. Axel Hernandez there. I think the first man to get contact was Murray.
Not much for Vasquez, and nobody can get yards when a defensive lineman penetrates. Check out Axel Hernandez. He was there right away. Remember at the beginning of the year, Axel Hernandez started out in the middle linebacker position, so he's been moved up to the line.
And here the quarterback wants to initially throw it. Now he's going to run and has some room up the middle all the way down to the 21-yard line. That'll be just short of a first down, but it'll be third down.
And Trey Guajardo comes into this game with not a lot of yards, about 200 yards rushing, Mark, but he likes to pick up yards when they need them.
Yeah, he's the second leading rusher on this team. Like you said, they don't throw much, as Guajardo is going to take a quarterback draw here and gets the first down all the way up to the 16-yard line, a gain of five on third and one.
I mean, this offense looks real programmed, Mark, real like a fine machine just mixing up the run and the throw.
And the Bears quickly run a play, headed off to Vasquez, who sheds a tackler, runs up to the 12-yard line before Bazan tackles him.
And there is a penalty on that play, and we'll see what it is.
Offside, defense, number 18.
Defense offsides, so that's going to make it a first and five.
Yeah, I think they'll take it. They picked up four, but it'd be second and six versus first and five.
Referee Fred Gracia, joined by umpire Jose Villasillos. Headlines by Mario De León. Line judge Eduardo Segovia and back judge Ronald Jackson. You know, Mark, I was part of, at the beginning of the game, the referees come out and they speak to the coaches, and I was able to listen to that. That was pretty interesting what they talk about.
And Guajardo on first and five is going to roll out to his right side, throw toward the end zone. It is knocked away and incomplete. Threw into a bit of a crowd, and a good coverage there by the linebacker, Pequeño. And, of course, Pequeño also experienced as a defensive back, so he's comfortable in pass coverage.
And that's what the defense has to do, is try to rush Guajardo.
It's intended for Castillo.
Didn't have enough time to find an open receiver and kind of forced it in there.
Second down and five. Guajardo back to throw. Now flushed out. He's going to get sacked. Mustangs on top of him. That's one of the things you talked about, Mario, is the defense needs to kind of step up, and they've come up with two big plays now.
And I'll give that credit to the defensive backs and the safety. Guajardo had nowhere to throw, and he had enough time, but after that, the pocket kind of broke away. Number 9, Nick Nelson.
Got the sack. A 1 yard loss as Guajardo on third down throws over the middle. Caught at the five into the end zone for a touchdown. The ball did come out, but they're ruling that he crossed the plane. That was Marco Guajardo made the catch, crossed the plane into the end zone for the touchdown. Ball was knocked out, but not until after he got into the end zone. And it's a touchdown for the Bears. They lead it 6-0, 7:53 to go here in the first quarter.
And that's Marco Guajardo's 30th catch of the year and touchdown number 7. Marco Guajardo is the son of the head baseball coach at PSJA.
Here's the extra point try. Castillo is the holder. Good snap and hold. Kick is up and away. And good. It's good by Jacob Sanchez, the kicker. And the Bears lead it 7-0 over the Mustangs here just 4 minutes, 7 seconds into the first quarter. Let's take another look at the touchdown. Cesar Guajardo found the open man, Marco Guajardo, at the 5 who got into the end zone. You can see he was over the goal line before the ball was knocked out. So 7-0 Bears, you're watching Football Night in McAllen. Back to VQ Fan Field at McAllen Veterans Memorial Stadium. Bears take the opening kickoff, 67 yards in 10 plays. Drive of 4 minutes and 7 seconds, a 12-yard pass from Trey Guajardo to Marco Guajardo for the touchdown. For Trey Guajardo, that is his 16th touchdown pass of the season. So Bears kick it off, be fielded by the Mustangs. This is Gregory on the left side. He's going to run it all the way back to the right. Has some room over there at the 25. Now at the 30, picks up a wall at the 35, the 40, and out of bounds at the 45-yard line. So that looked like a planned play, not improvisation on Gregory's part, as he started up to the left and then darted back to the right, used his speed to get all the way over there. Mustangs had a wall set up for him, and it's a terrific kickoff return for Memorial.
Exactly what the Mustangs needed, a special teams play to start off on their 46-yard line. And Mark, now we know why Trey Guajardo is so accurate. Short, safe passes, and that's the type of offense that Lupe Rodriguez runs. There were no big, long passes of more than 10 yards. It's short passes, and it leads to a lot of success.
Yeah, we'll talk more about Lupe Rodriguez, the Bears coach, in just a moment. One of the top players in Valley history, as we do a wildcat on the Mustangs' first play from scrimmage. This is Campbell Spates, lined up in the shotgun, who runs it for a gain of about 1 yard.
Offside, number 6.
Penalty
defense.
On the defense, so that's a Five-yard good penalty. Break for the Mustangs.
Still
put themselves
down.
In a first and 5 situation. I wouldn't expect the Mustangs if they try to. Traditionally, we know that Coach Littleton has had a lot of success running the ball, and when you have a running back like Campbell Spates, who came into this game with 667 yards rushing, 7.3 average, 10 touchdowns, you know that you want to run the ball.
So Lotta will be under center. We'll hand this off to Castro, the fullback, and he's hit after about a 1 yard gain, forced back by the Bear defense.
Jacob Sanchez in on the tackle.
So that'll bring up second down and 4. They have that 5 yard penalty. There, see the Mustang cheerleaders. You can see some of the pink there as it is October, Breast Cancer Awareness Month. You can see some of the pink on some of the players too. All the McAllen schools get into that during the month of October. We'll see it with, we saw it last night with Matt Kai, and we'll see it with Nikki Rowe. So second down and 4. Lotta hands off to Spates, off tackle right, has a big hole, picks up the first down. Brought down by the linebacker, Jacob Sanchez, who came in as the leading tackler for the Bears at 57 tackles.
A good job on the right side, and center Andrew Ramos. We know that Campbell Spates does not need a big hole to gain yardage.
6.5 to play in the first quarter, Bears up 7-0. Mustangs going right to left. They're wearing their white pants with the Colombian blue helmets, the golden Mustang emblem on the helmet, and then the navy blue jerseys. Bears in white pants and the white jerseys, white helmets with maroon. Spates on a pitch to the left. Waits for the hole to develop, gets up to about the 40-yard line, a gain of only two. Spates last week coming off a 130-yard game and a touchdown against the La Jolla Coyotes.
And that's what the PSJA Bear defense is going to do, Mark. The defensive end pinched out to make sure that Campbell Spates turned upfield.
You see Spates, only a junior. He's had 1,000-yard seasons, over 1,400 yards actually each of his first 2 years. He's on pace for that again this year. So you see some movement. Mustangs think it might be a free play. They throw the ball deep. It's incomplete, but there was a whistle. Referee Fred Gracia, an experienced crew here tonight.
Before snap, false start, offense. 5-yard penalty, still second down.
So second penalty against the Mustangs. This will make it second and 13. They'll move it back to the Bear 45. No win tonight. As I'll toss this right to Spates, cuts it back inside, is hit. He picks up most of the penalty yardage back, Spates. Back to about the 41. Gain of four.
On the 52, Mark, Robert Grimaldo.
On a game like tonight on Fridays, because I'm getting some text saying that they can only hear us call the game. And they want to see us, or they want to, you know, see the game.
Well, all they have to do is stay tuned, because UIL rules don't allow us to show the game live. But we are allowed to show the game or show the video of the game once the game is over. So once the game is over, the video is uploaded, and then we can legally show you everything. You'll be able to see it on demand.
So there's no technical difficulties.
Oh, no. It's a UIL rule. And here's a lot of going to roll out left side throws downfield. It's incomplete, intended for Bazan. Good coverage by the Bears defensive back, Andrew Beetst. Wonder if he's related to the famous composer, Franz Liszt. Maybe a distant relative.
Are you making up names, Mark?
No,
that's,
not at all.
That's real.
That's a Hungarian composer from the 19th century. You can ask the memorial band director, Mr. Martinez, about it.
Oh, I'm sure he knows.
See, we don't just talk about football in these games. We're an educational institution, so we talk about everything, as the Mustangs will punt for the first time tonight. And this is high and deep, goes into the end zone. It'll be a touchback coming out to the 20. Guarding us, the punter. We mentioned Skugan being out tonight. Skugan was also the team's punter. So Cardenas, the kicker, handling the punting duties here tonight. And that was a 41-yard punt with no return. But it's going to be a net of just 21 yards because it'll come out to the 20.
Well, Mark, one of our keys to the game was the Memorial defense. And actually, that was my number one key to the game. They had a couple of good stops, but not enough. You got to have three in a row.
So Bears' second possession begins at their own 20. 4:24 to go in the first quarter. Guajardo, a draw play to Vasquez, has plenty of room on the left side before he goes down after about a 7-yard gain. Knocked down by, it looked like Christian Sanchez got in there on the tackle.
This PSJ offense puts a lot of pressure on you, Mark, because they have five good receivers. You try to key in on all those five. And sometimes you can forget about J.R. Vasquez, who is a good runner.
And here on second down and three.
Very nice play on that one, Mark.
So quarterback Guajardo trying to keep it. Can be forced back by Sanchez, the middle linebacker.
Good sportsmanship.
Also Eddie Ramon, I think, in there on that tackle. You can see in the replay, Guajardo faked it to Vasquez. Mustangs weren't buying it. Murray also got in there
18,
along with
4-9.
Number 9, Nick Nelson.
Nick Nelson.
There we see Sanchez, only a sophomore, but starting that middle linebacker here tonight. Third down and one. And this is Guajardo going to keep it and pick up the first down.
I'm surprised the Bears haven't yet gone for the big bomb, but if you take a look at the defense, Campbell Spates is safety, and he's about 20 yards deep, kind of playing a The safety looking out for that long bomb.
And here Guajardo wants to throw. This is incomplete. Hitted for Castillo.
Flags all over the place.
And I think it was Pequeño on the coverage, but there are flags down. Bears have a first and 10 at the 33, pending the penalty.
Offsides on the defense, number 18. Penalty decline. Defense holding on an eligible receiver. On number 13, 10 yards, previous spot, first down.
Two penalties on the defense. And that goes to our third key to the game, lack of execution. Those penalties, cannot afford to have penalties like that when you know that on the field you're opposing a very tough offensive unit.
So 3:01 to play in the first quarter. Bears pick up 10 yards and a first down at the Bear 43. Moving from left to right, we'll send a man in motion. And Guajardo's going to roll out to his left and throw it incomplete, intended for Miguel Flores, who was the man in motion, ran a short little five and out.
Great job by Diego Villarreal. Mark, he had to follow the receiver that came, as you see him up on the top of the screen. He had to follow him all the way to the other side of the field, and he stayed with him and did a good job. Diego.
And Flores looked like he may have been able to come up with that, but Villarreal broke it up. Guajardo under center, looking left, now going to throw over the middle on the slant route, and it's caught by Castillo. Going to be short of the first down. Right at midfield, a gain of seven on the play.
But all these short yard gains, Mark, it puts you in a situation for a short yardage when you get to third down. It's third and three. Everything is open.
And here on third down and three, Vasquez trying to get to the outside. Won't get there.
Ethan Bazan.
Ethan Bazan.
Yeah, great play by Bazan, playing both ways tonight. Nails him for a one-yard loss.
We're going to have a timeout, Mark. Coach Lupe Rodriguez wants to talk about it. You know, you're at the 49-yard line. We'll find out if he's going to go for it on fourth down.
Yeah, fourth down and four now after the loss of a yard. Timeout Bears. First quarter, 2:09 to play. 7-0 Bears in front. And decision time here for the PSJA Bears. Their head coach, Lupe Rodriguez. People have been following Valley football for a long time. Or at least since the 1980s, will recognize that name, won't they?
They will. He kind of started that spread offense. I mean, all of a sudden, from nowhere, all these teams used to like to run the ball, Mark. And then all of a sudden, Mission, to me, I remember him as that school that started that throw that ball behind Lupe Rodriguez, and then you had Coy Detmer. And
you remember the receivers, Matty Valdez and Frank Hernandez, who I think coaching, also in the coaching ranks. They were two of the top receivers in the state around that time, and Lupe Rodriguez was the quarterback on those Mission Eagles in the late 80s under Coach Rusty Dowling.
And I saw him warming up earlier, and he still has a good arm.
Oh, yeah, I bet. But here's Guajardo on fourth down, going to run this straight ahead. Great blocking by the Bears, and they pick up the first down into Mustang territory to the 40-yard line, a gain of 11.
According to the offensive line, they made it easy for Trey Guajardo, a good athlete, doesn't need much help. But that was pretty much a very strong push by the entire offensive line for the Bears.
I actually spot this at the 41, so yeah, a gain of 10 on the play. Bears have 46 yards rushing. A minute 40 to go in the first quarter. This is their second possession. They got a 7-0 lead. Guajardo out of the gun. As Vasquez to his left, going to throw over the middle, and this is broken up. Bazan with another big defensive play. It's intended for Marco Guajardo.
I don't know if they're going to continue to try to go at Bazan. Because Bazan, if you want to know how to play defense as a defensive back, take a look at this play. Bazan did a good job of making sure that he did not get a penalty.
So this will be second down and 10. Guajardo play action. Now being forced out of the pocket. It's going to take off and run with it. Has a lot of room. Bates one tackler is hit downfield, brought down by Gregory, who's also playing two ways tonight. but not before he picked up a first down all the way to the Mustang 27.
And that's the beauty of a quarterback that can run, Mark. When something doesn't work and you have the speed that Guajardo has and the moves, he looked like a running back right there.
Gain of 14 on the play. And Guajardo on first down for the Mustang 27, rolling out left. Throws, it's intercepted by the Mustangs. Mustangs run it back from the 20 to the 27. And the Mustangs have the first turnover here tonight.
Exactly what the Mustangs needed, Mark. Michael Morales, the right place at the right time.
Yeah, Morales' third pick of the season. And he's the only one on defense who has an interception. They've had three interceptions as a team, and Morales has all three of them. So we take a look at the replay. I think Guajardo never saw him, as it seems like he threw right to him.
Well, what happened was he also had pressure by number four, Quade Murray. That helped out a lot. And Quade is not going to get credit for the interception, but he should get an assist because he forced Trey Guajardo to rush the pass, and Michael Morales playing good defense.
That pass was intended for Justin Morales as Mustangs on first down. As we take another look at this replay, you can see there, good interception by Morales.
Good hands.
And the Mustangs with a 1 yard gain. There was a Spates who carried it. So they have second and nine now from the 28 yard line. They're going to hand off Castro. Bring a trap play back to the right. Has good yardage all the way up to about the 39. And the first down.
Manny Castillo on the tackle, but that's a first down for the Mustangs. And that should be the last play of the first quarter.
By the way, only the second pick that PSJA's quarterback has thrown all season. He's not one that throws those very often. Very accurate quarterback, but the Mustangs do have a turnover. As we reach the end of the first quarter, the Bears lead it 7-0 over the Mustangs. Mustangs have the football when we start the second quarter. In a moment, you're watching Football Night in McAllen.
At Lone Star National Bank, we're making a difference. Because we believe prosperity is best measured by the communities we help build and the lives we help change. Lone Star National Bank, proud to be the Valley's bank.
And welcome back. Start of the second quarter. Spates takes a toss to the right and is held to a short game.
And here's where you miss John Scoogins, because remember Joseph Lada probably just had this week of practice where he knew he would be starting. It takes a lot of practice to get those pitch outs correctly.
And it's actually going to be a loss of a yard. So becomes second and 11 at the Mustang 38. And they in the Wildcat, they snap it to Spades, but there
Ball
was a flag down.
Offense, number 83. 5 yard penalty. Still second down.
That'll move it back to the 33, and now it's second and 16.
You know, we've known Coach Littleton for a while. Don't be surprised if he gets a couple of gadget plays out there.
Yeah, we saw the Mustangs did that against Mission.
Yeah, so be expecting that sometime in this game.
So second and 16, tight end Baz is on the right as Lotta's going to hand this off to Spates. It's a flea flicker, and they're going to throw it. Lotta's throwing it deep over the middle, and it's intercepted. Intended for Bazan, but picked off by the Bears, Juan Zambrano.
Juan Zambrano in the interception for the Bears.
So Mustangs do pull one out of the bag of tricks. And they had Bazan on the post route, but excellent coverage by Zambrano to pick this one off.
Give credit to the defense, Mark.
There was a handoff to Spates. Spates turned around, flipped it back to Lotta for the flea flicker.
It could have been one of those plays that would have worked.
And then the Bears weren't fooled. They were down there with Bazan and Zambrano picking that one off. And Zambrano, one of the top defenders on this team. That's his fourth pick of the year. Bears start off at their own 35-yard line after the pick. And here's a big run here. That's the quarterback taking off, got three of everybody's at the 10, all the way down, tackled at the 1 yard line. A touchdown saving tackle by the Mustangs, Diego Villarreal, who chased Guajardo all the way down the field. But a huge run there by Guajardo.
What made this play work is that you have the running game and you have the passing game both going at the same time. What do you do? And then you have Trey Guajardo with a tremendous fake. I even thought he gave the ball to J.R. Velasquez. What a hustle play right there, Mark.
Yeah, time to just rise, you see on the replay, to catch his feet at the one, but on first and goal, they hand off Vasquez, hit at the goal line, second effort, gets into the end zone, a touchdown for the Bears. J.R. Vasquez plunges in for his fifth touchdown of the season, and the Bears have a 13-0 lead over Memorial.
And you start banking so many other businesses that make this district program possible.
You see the Bearettes happy about that. They'll be attempting the extra point now. Jared DeLeon, the kicker. That's up and it is good. And the Bears now are 2-for-2 on their extra point tries, and they lead this game 14-0 with 10:15 to play in the second quarter. Let's take a look at the replay here again. This is the touchdown, first and goal. They hand it off to Vasquez. This is after a 64-yard run by Guajardo, and Vasquez the last yard for the touchdown. The Bears on top by two scores. We'll be back in a moment on Football Night in McAllen. DQ Fan Field at McAllen Veterans Memorial Stadium. Mark May with Mario Rada, MITV crew, McAllen Instructional Television, bringing you an exciting season of football night in McAllen. You have all the home games of the Nicky Rowe Warriors, Mackay Bulldogs, and the Memorial Mustangs. Mustangs and PSJA Bears tangling tonight. The Bears lead it 14-0 here early second quarter. Here's the kickoff. It's going to be fielded at about the 13-yard line by Gregory for the Mustangs. Running left to right, comes up straight ahead to 30. Still has some room dancing through across the 35 all the way up to the 36-yard line.
Pretty good moves by Campbell.
Every Bear had a shot at him on that run.
Okay, now's the time for the Mustang offense to get themselves going.
Take a look at the replay. Campbell State's helping out on the play there. Actually, it was Spates that returned it. And Gregory blocking for him as they hand off Spates on first down from the 36 and up to the 39-yard line, a 3-yard pickup.
You know, on the defensive side, when the Mustangs have a new quarterback,
Jacob Sanchez,
they're going to be loading the box, and that's what the PSJ Bear defense is doing. They're putting 6-7 right in the box, challenging the Mustangs to put the ball in the air. But when you have that many defenders up in the box, Mark, it's hard to run the ball.
Mustang fans there having a good time. You're right, PSJA really trying to stop that run. Second up close to the line of scrimmage, handoff to Castro, the fullback. And he's hit right at the line and wrestled back by several Bears, including Pablo Trevino, their linebacker. So got back to the line of scrimmage. It's going to bring up third down. Mustangs 0-for-2 on third down. 9 minutes to go here in the second quarter. Third down and 7 for the Mustangs, their own 39. Four down lineman for PSJA. This will be a shotgun snap to Vada, rolls out to his left. He's going to throw the ball. This is caught at about the 49. That's going to be a first down for the Mustangs. And then the ball comes out, and I think this is going to be ruled a fumble.
And it's Bears ball. It's Bears football.
Official timeout for an injury.
Ball appeared to come out a little bit late, but I saw the beanbag of the official go down to indicate a fumble. And then it took a moment for them to uncover the pile and figure out that it was the Bears who had recovered as we take a look at the replay. And hard to tell exactly when the ball came out. You can see the receiver's knee hit down, but can't quite see when the ball came loose. But the official on that side of the field with a clear view rules it a turnover. And the Mustangs have turned it over twice on as many possessions.
Unfortunate for the Mustangs, because that was clearly a first down. And also it could have been a, as we take a look at the replay, looks like the ball did come out before any his knee hit the ground. But Mark, that's unfortunate for the Mustangs, because that would have been a very good confidence booster for Joseph Alada.
Yeah, they did pick up 14 yards on the play, and then the fumble right at the end. So it's Bears football. The spot of recovery at their own 47. 8:35 to go, and Guajardo's going to throw deep on first down, and this is overthrown, intended for Marco Guajardo, who caught the a touchdown pass back in the first quarter.
Marco Guajardo, a very good athlete, also on the track team. And if you're going to have a quarterback that misses, Mark, you prefer to miss by overthrowing, because it's not going to be intercepted. But Isam Bazan has been a very busy individual on offense, running a lot of offensive patterns as a receiver, and also playing defensive back.
Yeah, he was defending on that play. So we take a look at Eddie Ramon, the defensive end. Second down and 10 now for the Bears. Guajardo out of the gun. Plenty of time over the middle. It's caught. And a big first down here at the 40 in Mustang territory, all the way to the 30. Before Miguel Flores is forced out of bounds. Pickup of 23 yards on that reception.
Bazan, so many weapons, Mark. So many weapons.
We take a look at that replay. You can see Flores, I believe his first catch of the evening. Otto also helping out on that tackle. Here's Vasquez. Hopping over one defender, then hit. Big tackle there in the open field. That was Bazan. Bazan having a heck of a night
here,
playing two-way football.
He's going to end up being first-team offense and first-team defense, Mark.
Three-yard gain by Vasquez. So we take a look at Bazan, the senior, who's featured in our sideline show earlier this evening. Wants to go into business. He has some... members of his family are in business, and he'd like to own his own business someday. As Guajardo on second and seven throws over the middle. It's tipped and then caught by Flores, who had to make a leaping acrobatic catch as that ball was tipped at the line of scrimmage.
Another first down. Boy, everything's going the PSJA Bear way.
Yeah, gain of 9 on the play. We take a look at this replay. See Guajardo's pass tipped by a defensive lineman. But Flores able to stop in his tracks and leap for the football and catch it, just like a jump ball in basketball. And now a throw over the middle. This is caught. That's Marco Guajardo. First and 10. Completes it up to the... Actually, it's going to be short of the first down. So the second down. So a gain of 6. So it's up to the 12-yard line.
Ethan Bazan is matched up against Marco Guajardo.
So second down, Guajardo out of the shotgun, rolling to his right, has plenty of time, now wants to keep it at the 10, cuts into the 5, then hit, and down around the 2, maybe the 1. They're going to spot him at the 2, and it'll be first and goal from there.
And on that rollout, Guajardo has an option of running or throwing. Did not find a receiver. Diego Villarreal, once again on the tackle. But once Trey Guajardo decided to run, he showed his quickness.
Yeah, he's decisive once he decides to go with it. He has that deceptive speed. Had one run for 64 yards earlier in the quarter that set up their second touchdown. First and goal from the 2, Guajardo out of the gun, throws into the end zone, caught, touchdown Bears. Marco Guajardo with his second TD catch of the evening. And the Bears open up a 20-0 lead over the Mustangs. 6:21 to go here in the second quarter, and it's been all Bears.
If you're not going to be able to put pressure on Guajardo, that means the offensive line doing a good job, Mark. And like any quarterback, you give them time, they're going to find their open receivers. He actually had like two other open receivers, Mark.
Here's the extra point try, pulled by Castillo. Extra point is up and good by De Leon. He's 3 for 3 with 6:21 to play in the second quarter. It's the Bears 21 and the Mustangs nothings. We go to the smile cam now here at DQ Fan Field. Some of the students up there, they see themselves on the scoreboard. They get excited. Having a fun time here tonight, this Friday night. Terrific weather for football.
And nobody wants to be down 21-0, Mark, but let's not forget that Memorial was down 28-7 against Mission.
But they came back and won that game by 4.
They did, but it's not looking good for the Mustangs. But
and here's Billy on to kick this off for the Bears. This will push the Mustangs all the way back to their goal line. And got to run it out. That's Gregory with it. He evades one tackler at the 5, now to 10, 15, 20, and then hit and forces his way all the way up to the 25-yard line. Terrific return there. And one of the tacklers, Joey Garza, for the Bears. Mustangs have had 2 turnovers in this game, and both have led to Bear touchdowns.
That goes back to one of our keys to the game, execution.
Look at the replay. You can see Gregory walking a tightrope there on the sideline, just refusing to go down. Earl Vianca also in there on their tackle. Mustangs first and 10, their own 24. Going to toss it left to Spates. Spates hit at the line, surges forward for a gain of 2. Brought down by the linebacker, Sanchez.
And it doesn't matter who the running back is, Mark, whether it be in the NFL or college, if your offensive linemen are not opening up holes for you, you're not going to be able to get those yards.
We're at 5:45 to play in the second quarter. Mustangs do have all 3 of their timeouts.
And because there's still 5 minutes to go, Mark, it's important that the Mustangs try to get themselves a couple of first downs. Don't want to give that ball back.
And Bears threatening to blitz here. As Lotta, 3-step drop, is going to throw this one. This is caught by Bazan. First down across midfield into Bear territory at the 47-yard line. So a great read by Lotta to spot the blitz and then hit Bazan running on a go route straight down the field.
That was a great pass.
On defense.
It is
penalty decline, result of
play. On the defense, so the Mustangs needed that big time. Give Lara some confidence that he can complete some passes.
Yeah, 27 yards on this pickup. Lara was kind of hit as he threw the ball.
Ethan was in between 3 PSJ defenders.
Mazan tackled by Leitz. And on first and 10, the Bear 47, they give to Spates, who's hit in the backfield. It's going to be hit for a loss. Great defending by the Bears. Number 90, Manny Castillo. First one there. He's second on the team in tackles. Castillo, just a junior, came in with 52 tackles tonight. And a loss of 2 on the play. We'll take a look at that replay. Let's look at the pass play from 2 plays ago as they hit Bazan there on the right side. 27-yard pickup. Mustangs' biggest play from scrimmage tonight. They're now second and 12 at the Bear 49. Now with an eye backfield behind Lottitz, Castro and then Spates dotting the eye. Wing back left. And Gregory split out wide.
In a hurry.
Play clock goes down to zero. I think the Mustangs call timeout.
Mustangs. First team timeout in the first half.
They get their timeout just before the play clock ran out, stopping the clock at 4:13 to go in the second quarter. Bears up 21-0. There we see big Taylor Dowd, the right tackle, 320 pounds. And you see the Bears huddle over there. Let's take a quick break. You're watching Football Night in McAllen.
We love a good game, but here at Bogus, we don't believe in games and gimmicks when you're buying a new vehicle. Just real deals, friendly service, and fair prices. It's better at Bogus, in Harlingen, in McAllen, and always at BogusFord.com.
And we're back here on Football Night in McAllen. Mark May with Mario Reyna. PSJA Bears leading the Mustangs 21-0. Here, late second quarter, 4:13 to go. Mustangs just used their first timeout, facing a second and 12. They'll come out in the same formation with the wing left and Gregory split out wide to the left. Eye backfield. They're going to reverse this to the right. Big hole there for Bazan. Has room at the 40. Cuts inside. 30. First down and more. All the way down to the 27-yard line. So a gain of 22 yards and a first down.
You bet, because the PSJA Bear defense keys in on Campbell Spates. A little element of surprise. This direction. Very nice run by Ethan Bazan.
Yeah, 21-yard pickup.
Second big play of this offensive possession for the Mustangs by Ethan Bazan.
And brought down by Isaac Espino. First down at the Bear 28. They'll put Castro shifting out of his fullback position to the left. They're going to hand it off to Castro. And Castro hit at the line, gets about a yard. He's following the block of Alex Escobar.
23. Arrington. Gate. A tackle.
So second down and nine. Clock is at 3:17 and counting here in the first half. Play clock at 12 seconds as Lotta comes up to the center. Eye backfield again with Spates dotting the eye. Toss it to Spates left side, the right side of the field. Cuts inside, big hole at the 20, at the 15. Now cuts it outside at the 10, the 5, and the touchdown. Touchdown Mustangs. They're on the board with 2:52 to go here in the first half.
Big response by the Memorial offense. Making sure they get something here. First half.
27-yard run for pay dirt by Campbell Spates, his 12th touchdown of the year. And Lotta will stay in there, the quarterback tonight. He'll stay in there as the holder on the extra point try. Good snap and hold, and Cardenas's extra point is up, and it's no good. It's wide to the left. So the score becomes Bears 21, Mustangs 6. With 2:52 to go in the second quarter, let's take another look at the replay. 27-yard run here by Spades. You can see just untouched. As he used those running instincts to first cut it up the middle, then bounce it outside and go to the end zone. 27 yards later for his 12th score this year. Bears up 21-6, late second quarter. We'll continue after this.
I always tell my students I'm a product of McAllen ISD. I always tell them if I made it from being in certain areas and certain schools and I'm successful, they're able to have that success or even reach and do more. So I'm very proud to be born and raised and be a product of McAllen ISD.
And welcome back to Football Night in McAllen. Another look at the touchdown run of beauty here by Campbell Spates.
Doesn't need much of an open hole.
Six play, 76-yard drive by the Mustangs. Their first score of the night. They trail now 21-6. with just under 3 minutes to play here in the first half.
That's still enough time
for them
time
to get the ball back.
Plenty of time for a team like PSJA that they love to pass.
And both teams with two timeouts. PSJA going from right to left. Here's the Cardenas' kickoff. This is going to be high and deep. It's going to be over the backfield, but bounces at the one, does not go into the end zone, so the Bears have to play it. Picking it up there at the 10-yard line and running it out to about the 12 is Marco Guajardo. And a perfect kickoff as it hit right at the one and then bounced straight up in the air. To do that 50 times to repeat that. But it bounced straight up in the air, did not go into the end zone, so the Bears had no choice but to run it out. And Guajardo getting out to the 13-yard line, so he took it with the replay. So the ball bounced at the two, actually. Bears left at first and 10 at their own 13. Left hash as Guajardo out of the gun, goes back to throw. Now wants to run it left side and is forced out of bounds at about the 20. Gain of 7 and stops the clock.
Holding. Offense number 63.
The Bears, they have a holding mark. That's going to pin them down.
Half a distance to the goal.
Half the distance.
Still first down.
Just their second penalty. And that one a bit costly as it wipes out a 7-yard gain. It's going to move him back to inside the 7 as we see the hold there. I think it was Axel Hernandez who drew the hold. So they're calling it first and 15, but it's actually about 17 as Guajardo runs this straight up the middle as a big hole there. Lotta finally upends him, but not before he picked up the first down at the 26-yard line. 20-yard gain.
You know, you got to give credit to the PSJA North defense last week. How did they hold the Bears down to 10 points?
Yeah, they need to frame that film from that game, as that was a defensive masterpiece. Albeit they lost, but still a terrific defensive performance by the Raiders. As on first and 10 from the 26, Guajardo fakes the reverse, throws this over the middle. It's caught, first down. Lotta with a big hit on Castillo. Castillo, a good job to hang on to the football. But this will move up to the 44-yard line, a gain of 18.
And just like that, they already got like 30 yards, Mark. No big deal for this offense to get big yardage.
Guajardo now over 100 yards passing in this game. You see a look at the replay and a textbook tackle, open field tackle by Lotta. So first and 10, Guajardo rolls out right, throws over the middle, incomplete. Looks like it was intended for Castillo. Oh, this is a team that is just masters of the crossing routes.
They love
You've
that.
Seen crossing routes
Short
left
passes,
and right.
All kinds of patterns, Mark. Very difficult to defend. You got five receivers going all over the place. All kinds of moves.
Yeah, a lot of movement.
And then you have the quarterback that can throw BBs. I mean, those passes are coming.
Minute 44 to go here in the first half. Still two timeouts as Guajardo back to throw. Nowhere to go. Now he's going to run to the right side, being chased. Evades one defender, but he's brought down by the linebacker, Sanchez.
And I think on that, I think Coach Lupe Rodriguez is going to talk to Trey and say, Trey, you can't get us. You can't stay inbounds when the clock is going to be running. You got to throw the ball away. And he was outside the hash marks. He could have thrown it away, but he didn't.
Yeah, you're right. He got no gain, and the clock continues to roll. Now at a minute 11. So Guajardo back to throw on third and 10. Throw over the middle. Receiver fell down as the ball goes incomplete, intended for Marco Guajardo. There's no flag anywhere, and that'll bring up fourth down.
Everybody wants a flag on that. Coach Lupe Rodriguez, Trey Guajardo, and the receiver, Marco Guajardo. Did Ethan Bazan get away with one on that one, Mark?
I don't know. You know, I saw Ethan Bazan there. He came over and kind of shook the hand of Guajardo and patted him on the helmet. He was kind of saying, like, you know, I've been there too as a receiver, and I know what it's like to fall down on a play that's intended for me, as we see Lupe Rodriguez, famous quarterback for the Mission Eagles.
They are
going to
punt,
Mark. And
they
has
are
that high-powered offense now here with PSJA.
Big stop for the Mustang defense.
First punt for the Bears, and Mustangs put on the rush, but they get the punt off. And this will be no return, as it takes a bit of a Mustang bounce to be killed at the 17-yard line with 55 seconds left in the first half. Mustangs still have two timeouts.
Three handoffs to Campbell Spates. See if he can break a big one, Mark.
55 seconds left. So the defense did its job getting the ball back into the hands of the offense. Yeah, see what the Mustangs can do. Here in the last 55 seconds. 21-6, Bears on top. And Mustangs come out with a passing formation. They've got Trips to the left. Lotta in the gun. He's got Castro in the block. And it's going to be a quarterback draw as Lotta tries to get forward, but the Bears are ready for it. They'll tackle him. It looked like maybe a loss. Manny Castillo, one of two Bears in there on the tackle.
Timeout. Mustangs.
And Mustangs use their second timeout. It was no gain for Lotta. So bring up second down and 10 from the 17-yard line. Mustangs down to their last timeout. Trailing by 15 points on the scoreboard. Mustangs came in at 1-1 in the district. PSJA at 2-0. PSJA tied for first with Nikki Rowe, who entered tonight at 2-0 as well. In fact, the Bears and Warriors will play next week. That'll be at PSJA. That'll be a Thursday night game, Thursday, October 18th. Nikki Rowe Warriors and the PSJA Bears. That should be a pretty good one.
It's going to be a tight race all the way through to the last week, Mark.
We'll have a good one here next week as well. It'll be a memorial against the Mackay Bulldogs. Big rivalry. Here the Mustangs. Lotta is going to be under center. Andrew Ramos will snap it to him. They toss it to Spates. They're going to reverse it to Gregory. Gregory runs into his own man. The Bears are all over him. And Gregory is going to be tackled at the goal line. Ball came out, hit an official, and stayed in the end zone where the Bears recover it. Now, there is no signal for a touchdown and no signal yet for a safety.
They have stopped his progress. Mark is going to be placed back at the two-yard line, but...
Boy, a lot that happening on that play. Is there, yeah, you're right. They're going to spot this at the two-yard line. A loss of 15 yards. That was the best-case scenario for the Mustangs. You see everything went wrong here. Spates reversed it to Gregory.
Ethan Masson almost going to get credit for the tackle.
Yeah, it was a PSJA's defender was Pablo Trevino, who was back there. That kind of messed everything up.
It was close to being a fumble.
Gregory was caught at the near the goal line where he was hit by about four defenders, and as he fell down back into the end zone, the ball came out.
That could have been a fumble, Mark, and the Mustangs got a break.
And the ball hitting an official's leg, and that's what kept it loose in the end zone. Instead of going out for an apparent safety, it stayed in the end zone where the Bears recovered, but no safety, no touchdown. It's Mustang ball at the two-yard line, third and 25. And they run this forward. Lotta gets it up to the four. And that
timeout. Bears.
I thought that might be the last play of the first half, but the Bears use their last timeout, or their second timeout, I should say, and stop the clock with 6 seconds left. So they want to force the Mustangs to punt and give the Bears possibly one play. But the Bears will use their second timeout. Stop the clock with 6 seconds. And the Mustangs picked up 3 yards and have a fourth and 22. They'll be punting from the back of their end zone. Cardenas will be the punter. And be his second punt coming up. Bears trying to force a play. Now, there's not really much time. I don't know if they'd be able to squeeze two plays out of 6 seconds. So we take
Mark,
a look
was
at the
this
replay
a fumble
again.
Or not? If it came up to you up here.
Yeah, I would say his progress was stopped.
That's right. Indisputable evidence, Mark. Okay. We'd have to go with a call on the field.
Ball was recovered in the end zone by Trevino. Trevino was a MVP on that play for the Bears. As he caused the havoc in the backfield and then eventually recovered a loose ball in the end zone. But it's a fourth and 22 for the Mustangs. Cardenas on his inline. Bears are rushing it, but he gets this off. It's going to be high and short. So the ball bounces at the 25 and goes out of bounds, but you heard the horn. We're at halftime, which is kind of the Mustangs dodge a bit of a bullet there because the ball would have been the Bears football at about the 23-yard line. But you heard the horn. We're at halftime, and the Bears and Mustangs go into the halftime locker room. The score is Bears 21, Memorial Mustangs 6. We're going to keep it here for a moment as we have our Teacher of the Week take this kick. This is put on by Performance Therapeutics. And there's a teacher, Miss Valeria Carpenter. And you can see her try for $100. Not quite. She tried to kick it through the uprights. But Miss Carpenter, who's an English language arts teacher at McAllen Memorial High School and also the sponsor of the Student Council. See, she wins a lovely parting gift from Performance Therapeutics, our Performance Therapeutics Teacher of the Week. And good effort, Miss Carpenter. So the band for the PSJA Bears coming out onto the field right now so you can enjoy their halftime show along with the halftime performance of the Memorial Mustangs Marching Band. And we'll leave you with that. I hope you enjoy our halftime performance. We'll be back with the second half of action in just a moment. At the break, it's the Bears leading the Mustangs 21-6.
This UIL marching band season, the McAllen Memorial Band is venturing out into the music of Mussorgsky, Lady Gaga, and West. Our soloists this evening are Philip Foley on trumpet, Alfonso Gonzalez on baritone, and Naisa Gonzalez on flute, and the flute section in our second movement. And now, under the field direction of Anissa Ortega, Cassandra Rodriguez, and Francesca Chavez, we proudly present our UIL show entitled Pictures. Pictures. section leaders are Alexandria Pina and Miguel Davila. The marchers of the week, Miranda Perales, Austin Martin, Silvia Tanguma, Jonathan Garcia, Nicole Payne, and Eric Arredondo. The seniors of the week, Ashley Gomez and Victor Garcia. Our section of the week, the flutes. And the prancer of the week was Melanie Martinez. The McAllen Memorial Band directors are Angel Martinez, Jeff Gunderma, Marcela Rodriguez, Mark Burton, Stephanie Perez, John Torres, and then the MITV. The Memorial Band would like to wish the PSJA Bear Band all the best leading up to the annual Pigskin UIL marching evaluations next week. We hope you enjoy the second half of the game, and go Mustangs!
And here we are at BTU Fan Field at McAllen Veterans Memorial Stadium. Our halftime score, the Bears 21, the Mustangs 6. Mark May with Mario Reyna. We'll take a look at some highlights before we start the third quarter. First half highlights here. You see the Mustang ROTC had everybody up in arms and ready for some good ball. And Trey Guajardo of PSJA threw this pass that was picked off by the Mustangs. He took him on the opening drive to give him a 7-0 lead. Then the interception by the Mustang defense, and the Mustangs had some big plays here, like this 27-yard run by Ethan Bazan, a 21-yard run. He would also have a 27-yard reception. And here's a toss to Spates, and this would be a 27-yard touchdown run for the Mustangs, his 12th touchdown of the season. And Bears were up 21-0 at that point. That made it 21-6. Mustangs getting on the board in the last 4 minutes before halftime. So that's our score, 21-6. Here's a look at the stats. The first downs, the Bears 15, Mustangs 6. Rush yards favored the Bears 158-79. Pass yards, Bears a little less than what they usually get. 103, Mustangs with 41 pass yards. 12 yards favors the Bears about 2-1 there. 261-120.
That mark is that they're taking what has been given to them. So
yeah, the rush yards has been there for them. So they haven't passed as much. Penalties were light, and turnovers, two on the Mustangs, one on the Bears. The one on the Mustangs were especially costly because the first Mustang turnover canceled out the Bear turnover and also led to Bear points, and the second turnover also led to Bear points. So 14 points off of two Mustang turnovers, and they lead by 15 right now as we start the third quarter. It'll be the Mustangs receiving, however, and they'll be going from left to right, and the Bears will be going from right to left.
And let's not forget, a couple of weeks ago, the Mustangs were down 28-7, and they came back, had a great third quarter, so we'll see if Coach Littleton can repeat that and make this a game.
Second half underway. Jared DeLeon's kickoff by the Bears, and Gregory will field it about the 12-yard line. And make that Spates on the return there at the 30-yard line. Now at the 40, still going, has a couple of blockers at the 40 in Bears territory.
Ow.
And then tripped up and down about the 36-yard line. Actually, his feet got kind of tangled up with one of the blockers there. The Bears had a couple of players down there, but Spates, a huge kickoff return.
I don't know why.
Over of about 60 yards there.
I don't know why anyone would want to kick off to Spates. I'd rather take a penalty, Mark.
Yeah, Spates was on the left side, normally where Gregory lines up. And Spates getting that kickoff return. And all the way down to the 36-yard line in Bear territory.
A quick score here will make things very, very interesting. The Mustangs are never out of it when you have Campbell Spates.
52-yard kickoff return by Spates as he gets the first play here on first down, all the way up to about the 32, and a pickup of 4. Bring up second down. Zambrano with the tackle, the defensive back. We're actually going to give Spates credit for 3 yards. So it'll be second down and 7. Bears have 7 men on the line of scrimmage as Lotta fakes the pitch and is trying to run to the right, but the Bears all over it. first hit by Castillo and a couple of other Bears in there, including Trevino.
Paulo Trevino. And no doubt a broken play right there, Mark.
Because he had no blocker on that side, so you're right.
He was getting ready to pitch out, but there was nobody to pitch out, and he did well not to turn it over.
So that's actually a loss of two on the play, and it brings up third down and nine. First half, Mustangs were 1-for-4 on third down. Here they have an unbalanced line to the left. They're going to toss it left to Spates there, trying to cut back inside, but the Bears all over that. Trevino there again, Castillo there on the tackle, and Isaac Espino.
Castillo, number 90. So you see him on the screen all excited, having a great game.
Had a loss of one on that play. And bring up fourth down.
Four Bear defenders that will get credit for that tackle.
So fourth and 10. The Bear 36-yard line. The Mustangs had a 52-yard kickoff return all the way down to the 36, but unable to go anywhere forward from there. But they're lining up as if to go for it here. And on fourth and 10, passing formation, two receivers left, two to the right. Lotta in the gun, has the ball go through his hands, and now sacked in the backfield.
And there's a penalty, Mark.
Almost got away, but yeah, flag is down. Is sacked by J.J. Barrientos. We'll see what the flag is about. The flag is two flags, actually, in the area where the quarterback went
first
down.
Face mask, defense, mark. Number 99. 15
it's
yards.
A big break spot for the Mustangs, Mark. First down. It's almost like a turnover, because the Mustangs were going to give the ball back to the Bears. And instead of that, the Mustangs keep the ball as you take a look at the inadvertent face mask. And so now the Mustangs have it at the 21. It's a big change of events here, Mark. It's like a big turnover.
It would have been sacked for a loss on fourth down. Instead, the Mustangs retained possession after a 15-yard face mask. Now at the Bear 21, Spates straight up the middle, has a hole there, a seam all the way inside the 15 to about the 13-yard line, a pick of eight on the play. Great blocking by the interior linemen, Gutierrez, Ramos, and Escobar.
You take a look at the Mustang student body. Kind of quiet right now.
Mustangs have in there Cesar Escaname in there at the fullback. They give it to Space, right side, trying to bounce it outside at the 10, down to about the 9-yard line. Good open field tackle there by
Leeds. Open field tackle right there, Mark, by Andrew List. Not too many kids can say that they are able to stop Campbell Space in the open field like that. From up here, it looked like once he had that opening, that Campbell was going to put on his typical moves to get into the end zone.
That picked up four to the 9-yard line. First and goal now for the Mustangs. 8:13 to go in the third quarter. Bears up by two touchdowns. Unbalanced line to the right side. Zlata's going to give this to Spates going left side. Has some room there, then brought down after a gain to the 6.
Number 11 on the defensive side, Jacob Sanchez.
I think Sanchez saved a touchdown there.
That almost looked like a typical run that Campbell Spates is able to take into the end zone. So you're looking at a second and about 6.
Yeah, second and goal. 6-yard line. Now they go unbalanced line to the left side. High backfield. They're going to toss it to Spates left with a lead blocker from Wada. And fighting his way near the 3, now the 2-yard line. Be brought down there to be third down and goal from the 2. Several Bears in there on the tackle along with Jaden Arrington.
So third and 1, Mark. Would you give it to Spates or just surprise everyone? Quarterback keeper by Joseph Latta earlier in the game. He was able to gain 2 or 3 yards. Is he going to be under center?
Yeah, Spate's got actually all the way up to the one. You're right. So it's third and goal from the one-yard line. Split backfield behind Lotta. They give to Spates going right side. Slices through. Hit at the one. Now fights his way into the end zone. Touchdown, Mustangs. Second and third effort by Campbell Spates. Gets his second TD of the evening.
That was pretty much all Campbell Spates. Determination.
Went right through the right side of the line. Ramos, Gutierrez, and Dowd providing the blocks.
That penalty mark really came back to haunt the Bears.
High snap, extra point is up, and it is good by Cardenas. And with 6:33 to play in the third quarter, PSJA's lead cut to 8, as the Mustangs now have 13 unanswered points, down 21-0 at 1 point, now 21-13. As you see, Spates fighting his way for that last yard to get into the end zone for the Mustang score. We'll continue here on Football Night at McAllen.
At Rio Bank, our goal is to help you grow and prosper with the right financial tools, quality customer service, and banking done with honesty and integrity. Rio Bank, your kind of bank, your kind of banker.
And we're back here on Football Night in McAllen. Mark May with Mario Reyna. And the Memorial Mustangs scored late in the second quarter, scored now mid-third quarter, and a 21-0 game is now 21-13. Thanks in large part to that man right there, Trevor, or rather Campbell Spates. He reminds me of Trevor Spates, his older brother.
Got you again, Mark. Got you again.
Yep.
Look at the determination. Most running backs would have gone down, but Campbell Spates is not most running backs.
Campbell Spates with
his congratulations to his brother who scored his first college touchdown last week.
That's right. Yeah, for the Stanford.
Stanford.
And Campbell with his 12th and 13th touchdowns of the season tonight as the Bears pick up the kickoff at the one-yard line as Miguel Flores runs it up near the 20 before he's forced out of bounds.
And that's the second time that a kickoff looked like it was going to go into the end zone, and it did. All right, one of our keys to the game is the Memorial defense, Mark. Can they make a big stop here?
We saw a shot of Marco Guajardo, who has a touchdown catch in this game. Actually, two touchdown catches in this game. Mustang scoring drive. They had a 52-yard kick return. Get to the rest in just a moment. It's on first down. They throw it outside to the right side. Good open field tackle there made by the Mustangs' Michael Morales on the receiver, Castillo.
Good tackle because he only allowed 3 yards. Those are the type of plays that go for big plays, especially when Marco Guajardo is the receiver.
And on second down and 7, they'll hand this off to Vasquez, big hole right side, first down 25, now at the 30-yard line, hit, now scores going at the 40, and tackled from behind by Gregory. A big run by Vasquez from the 16-yard line all the way out to the 47, a pickup of 31 yards.
With all these receivers and running backs, Mark, and quarterback, is there anyone on this PSJA Bear team that does not have any speed?
By the way, that Mustang touchdown had a 52-yard kick return by Spates, then the 8-play, 36-yard drive. As Guajardo on first and 10, going to throw over the middle into Mustang territory. It's caught by Guajardo. He's immediately tackled by Pizan. It's going to be a first
Miguel
down for the
Flores
Bears at
the
37.
Reception, Miguel Flores. But Mark, that throw right there, you see it on Saturdays. 17 yards, right on the money. Wasn't he an MVP last year somewhere, Mark?
That's right, District 31, 6A, where the Bears competed last year. He was the offensive MVP. Is on first and 10, the Mustang 37-yard line. They hand off Vasquez again, and after a 31-yard run, now runs it all the way to the 22, a 15-yard run, and another first down.
That's a quick 50 yards right there of two plays by J.R. Vasquez. He has to be somewhere in the 100-yard rushing category.
Yeah, 46 on those last two carries. As a team, the Bears are over 200 yards rushing, 204. tackle by Axel Hernandez, by the way. Pass over to the right side flat, caught by Morales, who was upended by Bazan at the 19-yard line, a gain of three.
The Mustang players like Ethan Bazan, Campbell Spates, even Lara going.
4.5 to play third quarter. Direct snap to Guajardo, who's going to run straight ahead all the way up to the 10-yard line. Is brought down by Sanchez, the middle linebacker. Ball's going to be up the 11-yard line, an 8-yard pickup. Another first down for the Bears. They first and 10 at the 11 now, as Guajardo, the quarterback, will keep it again and bounces forward all the way up to the 3-yard line, an 8-yard gain. It'll be second and 2. They do. This is a excellent Bears team. And there's a handoff to Vasquez on second and 2 as he surges forward to about the 2-yard line. I think he might be just short of the first down. They can pick up a first without scoring. We're down to 3:30 to play in the third quarter. It'll be third down in less than a yard. Third and 1 from the 2. Hand off Vasquez. Straight ahead. Touchdown, Bears. Big blocking by that massive offensive line of theirs. And with 3:14 to go in the third quarter, Bears have extended their lead to 27-13. Two touchdowns tonight for Vasquez. So Vasquez with the 2-yard run, had a 1-yard run in the first half. Sanchez will hold De Leon to attempt the extra point. A low snap, kick is away, and it is good. And so De Leon now 4-for-4 in this game, and the Bears lead it 28-13 as you see Vasquez plunging in for his second score tonight. The Bears extend their lead back to 15 points. We'll continue here on Football Night in McAllen. Football Night in McAllen at BQ Fan Field. PSJA Bears leading at 28-13. They led 21-0 at one point. Mustangs came back with 13 straight points. And the Bears have just marched down the field. 9 plays, 87 yards, helped by a big 31-yard run by Vasquez at one point, and a 15-yard run by Vasquez. And Vasquez capping it off with a 2-yard run for the touchdown, his second score tonight. And for Vasquez, his 6th touchdown of the season. Here's De Leon's kickoff, and he's going to kick this one kind of high and short. Actually, an attempted onside kick, and the ball's loose on the field. A flag comes down. Mustangs appear to have it. Yeah, Mustangs do recover the ball in good position at the 43.
They're actually lucky they got it, because PSJ had an excellent opportunity to come up with this.
Yeah, that was kind of kicked high like a...
Offside on the kicking team. Penalty flag. Kick catch in the first on a kicking team, 15 yards, first down.
So that'll move it all the way into PSJA territory.
Another good special teams break for the
say that was popped
Mustangs.
Up in the air like a pop flight of shortstop. The Bears tried to run underneath it. So we take a look at the replay here. See, it was pooched up to the right side, the kicker's right. Bears actually touched it first. But the Mustangs did recover it. You know, tuck on 15 yards to boot. And by the way, their big cheer you're hearing right now is for the Memorial Mustangs boys cross country team, which won the district title for the third straight year just yesterday. Congratulations to them.
Led by the Williams twins.
Yeah, also I think the Trevor Spates on right side has a big hole at the 30. Now at the 20-yard line, all the way down to about the 17-yard line before he's brought down by Espino. Big run by Campbell Spates. He's going to say the Memorial girls cross country, I believe, finished second. So both cross country teams doing very well. And Campbell Spates doing an excellent job here tonight. Two scores already, and then this big run here.
Throwing a block out there was quarterback Joseph Alada. And give credit to that sophomore right there, Isaac Espino.
First team timeout in the second half.
Timeout on the field.
And so for the PSJA Bears, their first timeout of the half, 2:57 to play in the third. Mustangs have it first and 10 at the Bears 18. We'll take a break. You're watching Football Night in McAllen.
Welcome to the What's Better game at Bogus. No matter how you roll, just pick the wheels to fit your style, new or pre-owned.
And we're back here at UQ Fan Field. 28-13, our score. Bears in front. First and 10, Mustangs. Bears 18. Straight ahead up the middle, up to the 10, the 5, and a touchdown for the Mustangs. They just popped that one right up there. That was the fullback, Escanane.
Nobody expected that. What a great call by offensive coordinator Devo Gonzalez. Everybody expecting another run by Campbell Spates. Boy, and once Cesar Escadame got that ball and he had the opportunity for an open field. He knew what to do with it, Martin.
Yeah, Escadame, the fullback, just popped that one loose straight ahead. Here's the extra point try. Snapped a lot of Cardenas's kick is up and good. And with 2:49 to play in the third quarter, the Mustangs have cut the Bears' lead down to 8 points again. It's Bears 28, Mustangs 20. After a terrific little 18-yard burst here by Escanane for his first touchdown of the year. And went straight ahead, untouched into the end zone, catching the Bears unawares. And Mustangs still fighting, down 28-20 here in the third quarter. We'll take a break. You're watching Football Night in McAllen.
Performing arts, the visual arts. You can find it all at McAllen ISD.
We're back here at DQ Fan Field. You're on this October 12th night, a beautiful, balmy October night. End of 2018 season. Mark May with Mario Reyna. There's the man who got the touchdown, Escanane. Escanami, Cesar Escanami is a senior.
Kind of like a drop play.
He's pretty stout.
That was kind of like a drop play. I mean, yeah, it just happened so quick.
Popped it to the fullback and you send your tailback outside and hope the linebackers follow him. And then that did leave the middle open for Escanami to race to the end zone. First touchdown of the year for him. And we have a whistle before they can kick it off. And the Mustangs have called timeout. You don't see that very often on a kickoff.
That's a very rare timeout, Mark.
The Mustangs used their first timeout of the half with 2:49 left in the third quarter. Bears up front, 28-20. Bears were on top 21-6 at halftime. And the Mustangs have scored twice here in this third quarter, and the Bears once, cutting it to a one-score game. That scoring drive by the Mustangs, remember the Bears attempted kind of an onside kick, which the Mustangs recovered. And then there was a 15-yard penalty tacked on that moved it all the way to the Bears 42. So the scoring drive started from there. Campbell Spates carried it for 24 yards to the 18, and then Escanane the final 18 yards for the touchdown. That's where we are right now. So here's the onside kick by the Mustangs. Ball is loose on the floor, and they've got it. Mustangs have come up with the football. And a timeout well spent as it's recovered by Michael Morales.
Coach Littleton rolling the dice.
Morales, a ball hawk, has an interception in this game and now recovers the onside kick, but no wonder the Mustangs electing to call timeout. And you can see that camera is right on the 50-yard line, so that's exactly where it needs to go, is 10 yards. And you can see it went just across to about the 48.5, and Morales falling on the football. So the Mustang football at the Bear 49.
And you know, you have to really, I mean, it's a big risk because you didn't want to give the ball at the 50-yard line to the PSJA Bears.
2:45 to go. They'll toss it left to Spates, who has to cut it back inside. Has a seam there across the 45 and still fighting his way forward. Whoa. Has a first down all the way up to the 36-yard line. Did the last 6 yards on second effort.
Somebody's excited. Somebody's motivated. Mark, that's one of the best runs of the year for Campbell Spates.
And a 13-yard run.
Here's the kickoff
for a first
again,
down.
Mark, it looked like one of the Memorial players kicked the ball.
Yeah, that was 23, Alex Gardenas, who kind of eased the ball over to Morales, allowing Morales to recover it. Maybe we can show that one more time. It's the Mustangs first and 10 in Bear territory. Toss to Spates left side. Is trying to break a tackle, but is pulled down from behind. Otherwise, he might still be running, but a good tackle by Robert Grimaldo.
He was so close, Mark. So close on that one.
Here's the onside kick once again. And you can see it was Cardenas, the kicker, who actually eased the ball over a little bit, and then Morales able to corral it for the Mustangs.
Also, Joseph Lara was designated. The defender.
3 yard pickup on there, so it's second down and 7. Mustangs up to 158 yards rushing in this game. Lotta is going to toss it right to Spates. Has initially had some blocks, but it breaks down, and the Bears bring him down for a little bit of a loss there. It's Jacob Sanchez who crashed through to pull him down back at the 34 yard line, so it's a loss of 1. That'll bring up third down and 8.
For
Mustangs
sure.
Have not done well on third down. There were just 2 for 6.
But we're definitely looking at two down territory with a ball at the 34. Mustangs are going to try to see if they could get that first down. And the good news for the Mustangs is that they're, by them being on the field, Mark, it keeps that PSA offense off the field.
Down to the last 41 seconds of the third quarter. Mustangs on the march at the 34, 3rd and 8. A lot of play action. Going to throw it long to the right side. It's caught at the 15-yard line.
Are you kidding me, Mark?
He threw it into double coverage, and Bazan goes up and out jumps the defense for the catch.
Not only did he out jump the defense, it was just saying, Ethan Bazan was saying, this ball is mine.
23 yards.
More.
Yeah, he squeezed in between two PSJA defenders, went up and grabbed that like a jump ball off the backboard. A 23-yard pickup on 3rd and 8.
Give credit to Joseph Lara, at least giving Bazan an opportunity to catch the ball.
So 1st and 10 for the Mustangs at the 11-yard line. So Lotta with an unbalanced line to the right will pitch it left. This is Spates with some blockers as the third quarter horn sounds, and Spates goes in for the touchdown. The horn almost cheering for the Mustangs in a way as Spates gets his third TD of the night. The Mustang fans love that. And the Stangs within 2 points of tying up this game.
I would think that Coach Littleton would more than likely go for 2 here to try to tie the game. What do you think, Mark?
At this point, I would say yes. They have 5 2-point conversions this year. Spates has 2 of them.
And the offense has gotten a little going.
So third quarter's come to an end, but they'll extend it for the 2-point try.
They need to hurry because they got about 7 seconds.
Yeah, they might have to call a timeout here. So Lotta with an unbalanced line to the left from the 2.5-yard line. Toss to Spates right side. Now he cuts this one up the middle and in for the 2-point conversion. It looked like the exact same play they scored the touchdown on, only instead of Spates going outside, he cut it up straight ahead and got 2 points. And we're all tied at 28. As we head to the fourth quarter, don't go anywhere. This game is going to be a doozy. We're tied at 28 after 3. Fourth quarter coming up. You're watching Football Night in McAllen.
The Rio Grande Valley is built on a strong foundation of family. We honor that tradition and are proud to announce that Elsa State Bank and Rio Bank are coming together to make a stronger bank for the Valley. Rio Bank, your kind of bank, your kind of banker.
We're back at DQ Fan Field. We see a replay of the touchdown by Spates. It's to the right corner of the end zone. They're playing the Rocky music up on the scoreboard. The Mustangs have come back from 21 points down. And Mario, you said it back in the second quarter. Don't ever count out these Mustangs. They were down 28-7 at one point against Mission a couple weeks back. Came back to win that one 42-38.
And maybe this game down 21, and they've come back to tie. Maybe that's their formula, Mark, to be down 21 and then all of a sudden come back. But that's a mark of a good team, a team that's trying to find their way. Twice being able to this season, down 21 points, to come back 28-28, down from 21, that's really not something that happens often. But they still have to worry about that PSJA offense.
Here's Cardenas' kickoff. Teams have switched in, so the Bears will be going left to right in the fourth quarter. And the Mustangs from right to left. We have a touchback, so PSJA will get the ball at the 25-yard line. Mustangs outscored the Bears 22-7. In the third quarter to tie this game up 28-28.
And going back to that penalty, Mark, that face mask.
That's right, it was on a fourth down.
Bears were going to get the ball on a fourth down in about midfield.
Yeah, that was on the previous touchdown drive, but here on first down, they hand off to Vasquez, the first play of the fourth quarter. And runs up for about 5 yards. Gets back to the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, no game. Mark, what do? You try to stop Vasquez, or you focus on Trey Guajardo and all those receivers? Very, very difficult.
It is difficult. They both had very stellar games. Second and 10 at the 25. Snap to Guajardo out of the gun. Has time. And now wants to run it. Has a lot of room. First down and more into the open field, and finally upended at about the 40-yard line, a gain of 15.
And then when you have broken plays where there's nothing, because all the defensive backs and safeties did a good job, then Trey will hurt you by running.
And Bazan with the tackle. First and 10 at the 40. Vasquez sweep to the left side, cuts through the Mustang defense, and is hit after a 10-yard gain and still up and still going all the way down to the Mustang 39-yard line. Looked like he was about to go down, but he regained his balance and surged ahead for 11 more yards. And a pickup of 21 yards on that play, all the way to the Mustang 39.
This district has some great running backs. Look at Vasquez, how he broke that play right there. He didn't go down, Mark. His helmet was almost on the turf. And then he broke another one.
Making all kinds of tackles. Took three Mustangs.
That is a highlight reel for J.R. Vasquez.
Finally brought down by Diego Villarreal. And here's Vasquez again, straight up the middle. Crosses from the all the way to the 30, passed to the 26-yard line, a gain of 14, and another first down.
J.R. Vasquez is possessed. Guess who made the tackle? Campbell Spates. J.R. Vasquez is probably saying everybody's giving the attention to Campbell Spates, but hey, I'm on the same field.
A lot of poise by the Bears here. Not to panic, although the score's tied at 28, simply focusing on what they do best. Got two big runs here, and now first down at the Mustang 27. They hand this off, and just fighting for short yardage this time. That was Guajardo, the quarterback, up to about the 22-yard line. Gain of 4 on the play.
Islas for the Mustang, Christian.
9:46 to play in the fourth quarter. Each team with two timeouts. We're tied at 28. Bears led at 1 point, 21-0. Guajardo goes back to throw. Gonna throw this one over the middle and too high and incomplete, intended for Marco Guajardo, who was guarded closely by Virial. That's gonna bring up third down.
Rare miss on a pass. Diego Virial was close to Marco Guajardo on that pass.
Yeah, Guajardo 12 of 20 in this game for 125 yards. Has two touchdown passes. Bears on third down are 4 for 6. Guajardo gives this to Vasquez up the middle, fighting his way forward, has the first down inside the 10, down to the 5-yard line. Before he's finally brought down by Pequeño, there'll be a first and goal for the Bears. 17 yards on third down and 6.
Misdirection, good holds on the right side.
First and goal at the 5. Guajardo's going to keep it, slicing over the left side and in for the touchdown. And Trey Guajardo runs in to put the Bears in front again, 34-28, with 9:08 to play in the game.
Number
75 yards scoring drive. 8 plays, 75 yards. Trey Guajardo, the quarterback, running in for the touchdown. Castillo, the hold. De Leon, the extra point, is up and it is good. De Leon, perfect tonight, 5 for 5 on his extra point tries. And the Bears lead it now 35-28. With 9:08 to play in the game. Take another look at the touchdown as Guajardo called his own number, running to the left side, and goes into the end zone for the touchdown. And the Bears lead at 35-28. You're watching Football Night in McAllen.
Don't miss out. Make sure you follow McAllen ISD on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. Also, subscribe to our YouTube channel. It is the best and quickest way to catch important information about McAllen ISD schools. Plus, you can see the latest videos. So get in touch with McAllen ISD.
We're back here on Football Night in McAllen. Mark May with Mario Reyna. Exciting game we've got here, 40. We talked about this in the pregame. Both teams, they generally score in the 30s, and they also give up points in the 30s, so it's about what we expected here. Yeah, those are your keys, the Memorial defense, the PSJA defenses. Both of them have had their moments, but the offenses have generally dominated here tonight. There's the Mustang Sally, Mustang Sam, entertaining the crowd. Or Mustang Stan, said Mustang Sam.
Don't change his name, Mark.
Yeah, Mustang Stan and Mustang Sally. The mascots. And here's the kickoff, can be fielded at the 5-yard line. That's Spates up to the 20. And then fakes his way left and goes back right. Has at the 30, spin move, and now at the 40, breaks a tackle. Now still going at the 50, turning into the open field at the 40 in Bear territory, going to the 30, turning on the afterburners, and he's going to score.
Why do you kick it to Campbell Spates?
95 yards. Campbell Spates, his fourth touchdown of the night. Oh my goodness, the first kickoff return by the Mustangs for a touchdown this season. Could not have come at a better time. And it's now 35-34. Mustangs down one.
Mark, and as he was catching it, I said, look out. I would not be kicking the ball to Campbell Spates.
And they have consistently kicked his way all night long on the kickoff. Extra point up by Cardenas is up and good, and we are tied again with 8:47 to play in this game. 35-35. Spates with 4 touchdowns here tonight, giving him 15 touchdowns on the year. Here's another look at this masterpiece of a return.
The patience.
Yeah, went left, then faked right, went back left again, did a spin move to escape one tackler, another
two
tackler
missed.
Picked up some downfield blocks from Gregory there. And then turned it back into the middle and outraced everybody for the end zone. That was a masterpiece by Campbell Spades. We'll go to the smile cam now.
He's smiling.
Yeah, everybody's going to be smiling after that run. That was something you never forget. 95-yard kickoff return. We're tied at 35. Eight and a half to play. And they got the smile cam going now, and everybody's excited. They've got the smile cam going right now, and I know somebody else who's smiling. That's our superintendent, Dr. Jay Gonzalez, who joins us now, and he's been enjoying this game out here tonight, along with all the other Mustang fans. And I'm going to call you Coach Gonzalez, as you used to be a coach. And Dr. Gonzalez, boy, this is an exciting game, and I know you must be excited because, I mean, you're an ex-coach, ex-athlete yourself, and this is what it's all about, isn't it?
Absolutely. To see the boys play so hard, and it's just a testament to the hard work that they put in. And both teams are playing hard tonight, so it's nice to see the Mustangs coming back and not giving up, and that's really what life's all about, so we're excited about that.
Touchback, by the way, on the kickoff, so the Bears will have it at their own 25-yard line. And you've talked about this before. I remember a couple weeks ago the Mustangs were down against the Mission Eagles, and you talked about some of the emotional intelligence qualities that you've preached with students and staff for the last couple of years, and how it paid off that night, and as they seem to be self-regulating again here tonight.
Absolutely. I mean, those five domains, when you look at self-awareness, self-regulation, motivation, empathy, and social skills, not only are those skills important in the game of life, but you get on the football field, and we don't really notice from up here, but the contact is extreme. The speed is this faster than it looks like from up here. And these boys, it's a violent sport. So all those five domains of emotional intelligence come in handy as they get through this this very, very tough competitive sport. So we're excited that that the kids play hard. And excited for PSJA as well. That's a good group of kids, well coached. So it's a friendly competition, but a competition nonetheless.
Yeah, and brings out the best in both teams, both schools, I think, as we saw Trey Guajardo run for a first down for the Bears. And 18 to go in the game, and we're tied at 35.
Any pressure on PSJA. 5-yard penalty. Still first down.
So it's a 5-yard penalty against the Bears, but it was after the run, so they did pick up the first down. But they'll now move it back 5 yards. Only the fifth penalty of the night on the Bears.
And we're talking about how tough the sport is. You get 8 minutes left in the game, and it really boils down to the mental side of it, Mark, and what team can stay focused on their assignments and what team can synergize and work together. And that's what's going to make the difference in the end.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah, big hit there. And the ball comes loose, and the Mustangs running it back. But I think they're going to whistle this an incomplete pass.
See a flag on the play that may have been, I don't know if it was a spearing call or what it was. Mm-hmm. It may have gone a little high on that one.
Yeah, we'll see on the replay in a moment. There was a flag down. It was a pass over the middle to Flores. And as soon as he touched the football, Mustang put him down.
Target on the 13 on defense.
And targeting, that gets you out of the game.
To the head of neck area. He's been disqualified.
Yes. Yeah, that's the rule, is a player who is called for targeting, even on the first time that they do it, any time that they do it, because it's such a, you're talking about injuries and things like that, so it is an automatic ejection. We take a look at the replay here.
Yeah, and we talked about how fast the game is. I don't think it was intentional, but we have to put that call into play just to keep our kids safe, because these kids are bigger and stronger now than they've ever been with regard to the weight programs and things of that sort. So it's nice to see that they're doing that at the NFL and all the way down to high school football to protect these young men.
There's a handoff to Vasquez for the Bears, who, after they move it up 15 yards to the Bear 46-yard line, Vasquez carries it for about 3 yards to midfield, and it'll be second down and 7. There was something that kind of kicked off this week that I know you were a part of and were excited about, the Youth Apprenticeship Program. And it's a partnership, I think, with South Texas College and the Chamber of Commerce. Tell us a little bit about what happened.
Very
there.
Excited about the partnership that we have with the Chamber of Commerce. Steve Elanius does a wonderful job working with the district as the CEO and president of the Chamber, and South Texas College and Dr. Reed. So the Youth Apprenticeship Program is giving students opportunities to pick up these apprenticeship jobs, really, their jobs, mm-hmm. to go out into the community and start getting their foot into businesses like Salt and House Wine and Bert Ogden and Clark Chevrolet and Atlas Heating and Cooling. There's just so many businesses that came out to help. And so we're excited about our business partnerships, and we're excited about this apprenticeship opportunities that we have for our students. And it's new to our district, and we're excited about it.
And that's great for the kids, isn't it? Because I know they went through kind of they went through job interviews, and they went through the whole thing. They had to, I know some of the students wearing a tie and everything like that. They had to show up and put their best foot forward. And it was we've got a timeout called by the Bears right now. And you know, and like you point out, though, these kids are going to get some real world experience. So they're getting the classroom training, and then they get to apply it in the real world too.
And I'll tell you what was most exciting is the feedback that we got from the business owners. They were very impressed with how prepared our students were for their interviews. So that made me very happy and proud. Our students took it serious, and they went in and competed strong. And there was only X amount of positions available. So it was a fierce competition, and our students did a good job. And there were some businesses that went in thinking they were going to hire one student, but students did so well that they hired 4, 5, and 6.
Oh, wow, wow. Well, that's great for the kids. And anything else going on? I know something you had in your e-newsletter that goes out to all the staff and all the community this week. You talked a little bit about in an effort to try to look better, we're inviting an audit from the Texas Association of School Administrators.
Yes, yeah. We do have a curriculum audit coming down. We know that we're an A district and we're doing very well, but the name of the game is fine-tune and improve the systems that we currently have so that we can continue on this path of excellence. So it's not that we're missing the mark anywhere. It's just a matter of, it's been 5, 6 years since our last curriculum audit, so we felt it was time for an outside entity to come in to tell us these are some adjustments that you can make to get better. So it's all about systems and processes and fine-tuning, just so we can adjust our game plan, much like the coaches do down on the field.
All right, very good. Dr. Gonzalez, thank you so much. Appreciate you stopping by, and enjoy the rest of the game. I know it's going to be a great finish.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
All right, Dr. Jay Gonzalez, our superintendent of schools for McAllen ISD. 6:20 to go here in the game. We're tied at 35. Bears on the march. They've got a first down and 10 at the Mustang 39-yard line. They give it to Vasquez. Nothing to the outside. Cuts it back up the middle and makes his way up to about the 36-yard line before he's brought down by Sanchez, the middle linebacker.
And what a nice interview, Mark.
Yeah, Dr. Gonzalez always has plenty of stuff going on.
He can keep him here the whole game, and he has a lot to talk because the district is doing so well under his leadership.
We've got a close-up of the PSJA helmet there. It's the PSJA and a big T in there. To tell me about that in just a moment, as Guajardo rolls out to his left on 2nd and 7, he's going to keep it, racing for the first down, and does pick it up as he gets out of bounds at about the 28-yard line. Again, of 8 on the play. What is the T on the PSJA helmet?
Well, I'm from, that's where I graduated from, so I can talk to that, you know, Far San Juan Alamo, and it's the T for Tri-City.
Tri-City.
Back in the day when it was only PSJA High School, we didn't have enough to have just a Far High School or a San Juan High School or an Alamo High School. Now they do, because they have like 4 high schools.
They've got 4 now.
But it is the original high school, like here in McAllen. The original high school is McAllen High School Bulldogs.
That was a fierce rivalry back in the day, the Bears and the Bulldogs. And here's it's been a big rivalry too, as Vasquez running to his right side is upended near the 20-yard line.
J.R. Vasquez is on a mission. It's a battle between him and Campbell Spates.
7-yard run. So it'll be 2nd down and 4. We're at 5:14 to go in the game.
You know, Vasquez only came into this game with 314 yards, Mark. But they didn't give the ball too many times, 42 times for a 7.5 average. But boy, oh boy, he's way over the 100 mark tonight.
5 minutes to go in the game. Bears with 1 timeout. Mustangs have 2 timeouts. We're tied at 35. Play clock down to 5 seconds. Guajardo taking his time. I was going to snap it with 2 seconds on the play clock. Wants to keep it as he starts out left, cuts back to the right, and goes up the middle to the 12-yard line. A gain of 9 on the play.
Tripped up by 67.
A lot of good athletes on that offense, especially at the skills positions, Mark. And the offensive line is huge.
And by the way, a first down there for the Bears as well.
75-72. Check that out on the screen. 76. Oh, yes. Big hits.
29 first downs in this game for the Bears.
A lot
of offense. The Bears with a first and 10 at the 12. Clock is at 4:19 and counting. Guajardo again letting the play clock wind down. It's at 7 seconds. Taking his time, using that senior experience, a four-year varsity starter. Going to snap it with 1 second on the play clock as he runs to the left. He's going to be hit in the backfield. Mustangs will be tagging him for a loss. A couple of Mustangs in there. Sanchez along with Nick Nelson.
Well, you know that the Bears are milking the clock here, Mark, and they're going to wait on the play clock because if they score, they don't want to leave a lot of time for the Mustangs. And the way it goes, if they get a touchdown out of this, they'll probably leave around 2 minutes on the clock.
And to keep in mind, they are in field goal range as well. There's no wind. Picked up only half a yard there, so second down and about 9.
Only one down lineman, Martin.
You're right, only one defensive lineman in a three-point stance as they throw this over the middle right side. It's caught and out of bounds near the 6. It was caught by J.R. Vasquez. And that'll stop the clock with they're keeping the clock running. He must have been tackled inbounds. So it's still running at 3:05 to go in the game. Tackled by Virial.
And here's where the coaches earn their money, Mark. What is Lupe Rodriguez going to do?
Also, Pequeno. Pequeno also in on that tackle. 5-yard completion.
Look for a run from Trey.
And it's a third down and 4 now. They've got 4 receivers to the left side. Unbalanced line. Is Guajardo in the gun, letting that play clock wind down. He's going to run this straight ahead. Quarterback draw, and he goes in for the touchdown. So the 4 receivers to the left was a decoy, and Guajardo runs in for the TD.
They did not give him a touchdown. They'll get a first down.
Right. Yep.
But they're not. I don't know how he didn't get a touchdown on that one, Mark.
Yeah, he looked like
he
went in.
Check it out.
But you're right, there was no signal. You see his knee does go down. Can't tell where the ball is, but it might be just short. And they rule him down inside the 1. So he does pick up a first down inside the 1-yard line. So a 5-yard gain.
7 seconds. They're going to have to call a timeout to play
and a first down. Clock is round down to 2:20 left in the game. And I think PSJ wants to call a timeout. Or maybe not.
They will call
play clock is only at 25 seconds, so they can just let this wind all the way down.
Memorial.
And Memorial wants to call a timeout, use their second timeout. So actually that call kind of worked in the Bears' favor because it allows them to wind the clock down even further before they score either a go-ahead touchdown or a go-ahead field goal. And the Mustangs decide to use one of their timeouts to keep the Bears from doing that.
You don't want to say this, but maybe it's just best to give them a touchdown so at least you can get the ball back.
And I've seen that before, that tactic before. Where you do, in order to prevent a team from winding it all the way down to a few seconds, let them score, knowing that you have enough moxie in your offense that you can come down and you have a good chance of scoring yourself. Highly risky move, but not unprecedented. So I thought Guajardo had gone in for his second TD of the night, but yeah, they ruled him down inside the 1. And Mustangs used their second timeout with 2:07 to play. The Bears have a first and goal inside the 1. Guajardo out of the gun, snap, quarterback runs it straight ahead into the end zone, touchdown. So a touchdown
safe
for the Bears
play.
With 2:02 to go in the game. Bears extend their lead to 41-35. Guajardo, the quarterback, with 2 rushing touchdowns here tonight.
Well, that's the safest play you could run, Mark. You don't have to do a handoff or anything. Big extra point.
It's a 6-point game right now. It'll be Castillo to hold it. And De Leon to kick it. De Leon perfect tonight on his extra point tries. Snap and hold. Kick is up and high, and it is good. And De Leon 6-for-6 tonight. And the lead is now 42-35. Bears have led throughout this game. They led 21-0 at one point. They were up 21-6 at halftime. Mustangs outscored them 22-7 in the third quarter, and were tied a moment ago until that touchdown as the Bears took their lead 42-35 with 2 minutes, 2 seconds left in the game. We'll be right back for an exciting finish.
A community bank with all the conveniences you expect. A real bank app, online banking, e-alerts, mobile check deposits, and ATM deposits. Real Bank, your kind of bank, your kind of banker.
And we're back here on Football Night at McAllen, and it's been a hero tonight for these Mustangs. Campbell Spates with 4 touchdowns.
And there's no way, no way he's going to get the ball. I can guarantee you that right now.
And last time he touched the ball on the kickoff, he ran it back 95 yards for a touchdown. Also has touchdown runs of 27 yards, 1 yard, and 11 yards tonight. Spates with 15 touchdowns now on the season. And by the way, with 4 touchdowns, that gives him 60 touchdowns for his career. Just halfway through his junior season. There, the Bears going to kick this one high and short, and the Mustangs will field it almost like a pop fly. That was Sanchez, who's a linebacker, but making a good catch there. And goes down so that he isn't tackled or giving the Bears a chance to knock the ball loose. And the Mustangs will have excellent field position. And by the way, that Bears drive, Mario, a thing of beauty. 12 plays, 75 yards, took 7 minutes, 6 seconds off the clock.
That's as good as a drive you can want.
That's as good as it gets. Check. But the Mustangs, that was kind of a, well, I guess the Bears figured it was better to give them good field position in their own half rather than kick it deep to Spates and give Spates a chance to run it all the way back. So the Bears elect to concede some yardage.
PSJA. They've had problems all night long. The PSJA kickoff team has been giving up big yardage.
So that's why the Bears kicked it short and given the Mustangs the ball at the 38-yard line. Bears just used their final timeout. And Mustangs with 1 timeout.
Let's give credit to Joseph Lara in his first game as a starter. Has managed the game very well.
We've got 2:02 left in the game. And the Bears up by 7 points. We take a look at some highlights from this game, and there's plenty of them.
Plenty.
There's a early touchdown. This was Spates in the third quarter, this was. So, you know, using that second effort to get in for the score. And that was his second TD of the night. And then here's Escaname, who scored tonight. And here's a pass by Lotta. It goes incomplete, intended for Gregory. Mustangs trying to catch the Bears unawares with the pass on first down. That goes incomplete.
And that is a good play to call, Mark, because everybody expects some kind of handoff to Campbell Spates. They did that earlier, and they were successful when they threw the ball to Ethan Bazan. Plenty of time.
What a game the Mustangs have had tonight. Without their starting quarterback, scored 35 points. They're down 42-35, minute 56 left in the game, second down and 10. Lotta out of the gun, gonna flare it out to Spates, the left side in the flat at the 40. Has room in the open field, up to the 50-yard line. And a gain of 12 and a first down.
What a nice touch on that pass by Joseph Lotta, leading Campbell Spates.
Mustangs with 15 first downs now in this game. Nevin Edetta making the stop for PSJA. Got Spates in the open field at the 50, but a 12-yard gain, first and 10 for the Mustangs. Minute 35 to go. It's a lot of back to throw. Going to hit over the middle. It goes incomplete. Man was open, but a little bit high for the intended receiver, and that was Nick Nelson.
Nick Nelson also playing defense?
That's right. He's playing both ways tonight.
Nice poise.
The quarterback playing both ways, too.
They gave him a lot of time. Probably a pass that Nelson would want another opportunity on. It did hit his hands. Right at the 50-yard line. Let's go overtime, Mark.
I hope so. Clock stopped at a minute 29. Second and 10 for the Mustangs. Lotta out of the gun with Spates in the backfield. Lotta back to throw. And Lotta now forced out of the pocket. Is going to run straight ahead up to about the 47 in Bear territory. And we've got a stop timeout by the officials.
Memorial.
At the third and Memorial.
Fourth quarter.
Memorial elects to call timeout. That was a 2-yard gain by Lotta. The clock would have kept running, so they elected to use their final timeout. So both teams are out of timeouts now. And the Mustangs facing a 3rd and 8 from the PSJA 48-yard line.
And Mark Lotta did a good job of avoiding a sack. And it looked like there was a holding that the Mustangs got away with. But then again, you want the kids to win the game on the field.
Yeah, it did look like a hold on the right side as Lotta was back to throw and then was flushed out of the pocket. So 3rd down and 8. Mustangs 3 for 8 on 3rd down in this game.
First things first, they need to get that first down.
Yeah, I would say 2 plays to Campbell Spates. He's been your bread and butter. As they toss it right to Spates, he's going to fake the reverse, and Spates keeps it on the right side. Still going at the 50, picks up the first down at the 40, and then out of bounds at the 30-yard line. It was a play they ran earlier that was disastrous when they reversed it to Gregory. That time they faked the reverse, and Spates keeps it for a gain of 18 yards.
That was by design, Mark. It was not a broken play, okay? That's only Campbell Spates doing what he does best, making something out of nothing.
Picked up a terrific couple of the downfield blocks by A.J. Castro. And so the clock stopped now at a minute 8 to go in the game. Both teams out of timeouts. Bears lead at 42-35. And Mustangs on the march are at the 30-yard line in Bear territory. Lotta in the gun. 3 receivers to his left. Going to roll out left. Looking downfield. Now it's going to fire it short. It's tipped and incomplete. It was tipped away by Castillo in the defensive backfield. It'll be 2nd down and 10.
And a little luck on the Mustang side there. Could have been intercepted. Lotta playing with a lot of poise.
And Castillo, number 5, one of those two-way players on the Bears team. We've seen him make some offensive plays here tonight, making a defensive play there. So both teams with some very tired players out there. The Mustangs on 2nd and 10 at the Bear 30. 2 receivers left, 2 to the right as Lotta rolls out right. Has time. It's going to throw it toward the middle. It's caught at the 20. First down to Moore at the 15. Now at the 10 and into the inside the 10 to the 8-yard line. It'll be 1st and goal for the Mustangs. Nick Nelson with the catch.
What poise, Mark. What poise by Joseph Lotta. The time right now down 42-35. They're going to put the ball down to stop the clock. But Mark, if we take a look at the replay, Lotta just like... He doesn't show that he's a backup quarterback. Look at him. Taking his time, finds the open receiver, and put the ball right where he had to.
That was a good pass, too, to lead Nelson because Lotta was running to his right, had to throw it back to the left and lead Nelson to the left.
And Nick Nelson making up for that other ball that maybe he could have caught.
So 1st and goal at the 8-yard line. Clock is stopped with 41 seconds left in the game. Bears up by 7 points. And Lotta under center, going to roll out left side, looking toward the end zone. Now reverses his field, throws it, and it's picked off by the Bears. Bears running it back at the 20, down the near sideline at the 40. No one's going to catch him. Now at the Mustang 40 to the 20. 2 players chasing at the 10, and it's a touchdown.
What an unfortunate situation.
Pablo Trevino with the interception. He runs
Joseph,
that back.
I think
95
Lotta,
yards for the touchdown.
I think Joseph Lotta, Mark, was just trying to throw the ball away. It looked like he was just trying to throw the ball away.
Yeah, he. I'm not sure if he was trying to throw it away or what he saw, but it was intercepted by Trevino. Ran it back 95 yards down that right sideline, all the way to the end zone for a Bear touchdown. And they now lead it 48-35. Just 21 seconds left in the game. Neither team has a timeout. So we take a look at the replay.
Sideline first.
Ilara was under pressure, and right there, it just seemed to me like he just was trying to throw it away.
That might have been intended for Spates, or might have been trying to throw it away. But Trevino stepped in front of that, made the pick. And goes 95 yards for the touchdown.
And I got to give credit to the captain, Daniel Domian. He gave it all he could to try to catch up to Trevino.
Yeah, Domian, one of the captains on this team, left tackle, all 235 pounds of him. He sprinted the length of the field after Trevino in a gallant effort to try to catch him from behind. A lot of pride on this Mustang team. And the Bears have opened up a two-touchdown lead, lead at 48-35. Extra point by DeLeon, up and good. He's been perfect tonight. It's 7-for-7, and the score now 49-35. Bears in front. Looks like they're going to get the win here tonight and improve to 3-0 in the district race. Mustangs would fall to 1-2 after what will be their second tough loss in a row. They lost by 1 point last week to La Jolla and were trailing by 7 with under a minute to go in this game. Had the ball first and goal at the 8-yard line. And then an interception by the Bears run all the way back for a touchdown. Here's a look at the schedule for the Mustangs. After tonight, they will be at home again next week against the McKay Bulldogs. That should be a good one. Those are always exciting when the Bulldogs and Mustangs meet. And then on Thursday, October 25th, they go on the road, play the La Jolla Juarez Lincoln Huskies. And then on Thursday, November the 1st, they're back at home against PSJA North. And then on Friday the 9th of November, the final game of the regular season will be the Mustangs against the Mickey Rowe Warriors. Warriors will be the home team for that one. Mustangs will be on the visitor's sideline. So some doozies coming up in the Mustang schedule. And certainly falling to 1-2 is not what they wanted, but they'll still be in the thick of the district race after tonight. And by the way, there was a penalty.
A big penalty, Mark, because of a sideline infraction by the coaches.
And our next broadcast you see right there will be McKay against Memorial Friday at 7:30, Friday, October 19th. Yeah, 15-yard penalty for a bench violation. I guess players running onto the field, perhaps, in celebration. And that moves it back to the 25-yard line where the Bears will do a squib kick. And Mustangs will field it at their 43-yard line. This is Escaname running the ball forward. Breaks a tackle in Bear territory now to the 40-yard line and still turning his way up to the Bear 35-yard line. Clock is stopped with 11 seconds left in the game. And Bears up 49-35. And Escaname trots off the field. Escaname with a touchdown earlier in this game, an 18-yard run that he had.
We have holding 10 yards in spot of the foul. First down.
So a penalty against the Mustangs for holding during the return. That'll move it back to the Mustang 48-yard line. An exciting, thrilling game here tonight between the Bears and the Mustangs. Campbell Spates with 4 touchdowns tonight. Escaname with 1 touchdown. And here goes Lotta. Back to throw on the what could be the final play of the game. He's going to air this out toward the end zone. The left side, the Bears back there. It's tipped, caught by the Mustangs, and a touchdown. Wow. A 52-yard touchdown pass. Tipped by the Bears, caught by Bazan at the goal line, who stepped into the end zone for a touchdown. But the clock is at 0. The game is over, and the Bears have won it. I think they'll still have the extra point try because sometimes that can figure into tiebreakers. But wow, what if this had been a one-score game and you saw this, the crowd would have blown the roof off the place. And here's the throw again by Lotta. A huge heave. It was tipped by the Bears, then caught by Bazan at the 1, stepped into the end zone for a 52-yard touchdown score. That'll look good on the score sheet. for Bazan, his fifth touchdown catch of the season. For a lot of his first touchdown pass of the season. And Mustangs will line up to go for two. They already have a two-point conversion earlier in this game. They're down, of course, 49-41. It won't affect the outcome. And Spates goes in for 2 points off the toss to the left. His second two-pointer of the night. And the final score is going to be PSJA Bears 49, Memorial Mustangs 43. And what a game between both of these teams. Exciting football. Tremendous pride exhibited on both teams. A lot of talent on both teams. Congratulations to both teams on a stellar effort. Trey Guajardo tonight for the Bears had two touchdown runs and two touchdown passes. His running back mate, J.R. Vasquez, ran for two touchdowns. And then Marco Guajardo, the receiver, caught two touchdown passes from his cousin, Trey Guajardo. And those are the Bears scoring. And then the scoring for, Trevino, the linebacker who had that interception return, also scoring the what proved to be the winning touchdown for the PSJA Bears tonight. And then for Memorial, they had four touchdowns from Spates, including a 95-yard kickoff return. And Escaname had the touchdown run. And then Ethan Bazan with the 52-yard catch for a TD. For a touchdown, Joseph Lotta throwing that pass. So final score, Bears 49, Mustangs 43. Hope you enjoyed it. Next week, Friday, October 19th, we'll have our next webcast for you. It'll be the Mustangs and the Bulldogs. Let's take a look at some highlights here, and we'll be going down to Jake Berry for to conclude the post-game show here in just a moment. But let's look at these highlights, and this is from right before the game started to the ROTC from Memorial. Excited for this game. There's Guajardo, a pass. This is after the Bears had taken an early lead of 7-0, and that pass picked off by Mike Morales, his third pick of the year for the Mustangs. And then here was Ethan Bazan with a nice 21-yard run that would help set up a Mustang touchdown, the only Mustang touchdown of the first half. And that was this play here, a toss to Spates. He had run it in from 27 yards out, his first score of the night. And it was 21-6 at halftime, Bears in front. Bears actually led 21-0 at one point. They end up winning this game by 6. But as we move on to the second half, the Mustangs had three touchdowns in the third quarter, including that one, a hard run by Spates of only a yard, but a tough yard. Probably four bruises for the 1 yard. And that was his second touchdown of the night. And then Escaname with this 18-yard burst up the middle. And the Mustangs were back in business. And then Lotta back to throw, threw this one deep. And look at that catch by Bazan right there. And that was on a third down and long play. That would set them up at the 11-yard line. And Spates would run it in for his third touchdown of the night right there. He would also score on the next play for a two-point conversion that tied the game at 28 as we headed to the fourth quarter. And then here's Spates right here. And that's the two-point conversion right there. That tied it at 28. And went to the fourth quarter. All tied. Bears regained the lead at 35-28, and it was tied at 35 on Spates' 95-yard kick return. And then this play, following the Bears' interception, that made it 49-35. And then Bazan catching the tip pass for a 52-yard strike from Lotta to him, Bazan. Bazan's fifth touchdown catch of the year, and they got the two-point conversion by Spates. And the final score, 49-43. Spates with a total of 28 points tonight, four touchdowns and two-point conversions. But the Bears ended up winning at 49-43, and kind of ironic that the winning touchdown turns out to be a defensive touchdown, as it was mostly all offense here tonight. But there were three Mustang turnovers tonight, and all three led to Bear touchdowns. Bears had one turnover, but that was negated by a Mustang turnover, and so the Bears winning here tonight on the road, their first road win of the year. And they will improve to 4-2 overall and 3-0 in district. They've won their third straight game. And Coach Lupe Rodriguez in his second year has the Bears poised to go or return to the playoffs. They were in the playoffs last year and might be in the playoffs again this year. At 3-0, they certainly have a good start. They're playing the alma mater now. We're about to go to Jake Berry in just a moment for the post-game show. He'll wrap it up from the field. And both teams have something to be proud of here tonight. Next games for the PSJA Bears, they will be playing the Nicky Rowe Warriors next week. And that'll be a Thursday night game in San Juan, or in Far, rather, as the Bears take on the Rowe Warriors on Thursday, October 18th. That'll be a 7 o'clock kickoff. As we mentioned, the Mustangs will be at home here next week on Friday, October 19th against the Mackay Bulldogs. The Mustangs will be the home team, Bulldogs on the visitor side. And that'll be a 7:30 kickoff. We'll have the pregame show with Jake Berry and myself starting at about 7:10. And then the countdown to kickoff at 7:25 and the kickoff at 7:30. And that should be a good one, Mustangs and Bulldogs, a rivalry that goes back to 1983. And we'll stand by for Jake Berry here in just a moment. Big game here tonight, a lot of offensive fireworks, exciting game, but the Bears do win it by a score of 49-43. Let's go to Jake Berry now down on the field to wrap things up. Jake?
Jake Berry with the Sideline Postgame Show. Coach, this has to be one of your better efforts this season. Wasn't the outcome you wanted, but your team played extremely tough.
Well, that's what I told the kids after the ball game. It was the best effort we had all year long. We come up a little short, but our effort, our togetherness, our teamwork, everything, maybe we turned some corners on some things that we've been having trouble with. I couldn't be more proud of these young men tonight. Even though it was in a loss, I couldn't be more proud of them.
And you, this week, you guys were saddled with your loss of Sean Scoogan, but Lada came in and played exceptionally well, you know, especially in the second half. What can you say about the performance of your team in general, but also him?
Well, you know, next man up, you got to tighten up the noose, you got to play harder, you got to challenge everybody else to do a better job, and that's what we did tonight. And take my hat off to him, he did a great job.
Thank you, Coach. Coach Bill Littleton of the McAllen Memorial Mustangs, they're going to face off next week here at home versus Mackay. For everybody at MITV, I'm Jake Berry. We'll see you next week.